Like, I talk for 5 minutes on this show and it's over. I'll never. I'm getting denied houses.
That's what
houses.
I love about
I
this
get,
show.
I can't even get fucking bank loans. Like, were you on KFC Radio? we can't trust this fucking guy. Are you ready?
Frankie's here. Frankie Borelli.
What's up, Francis?
Yeah, baby.
Frankie's back. Frankie's back.
Dude, I've been having urges recently to just moan. Like, bro, I said this to fucking Trent the other day during a golf trip. We were standing in a fucking airport, and I'm like, I just want to moan so loud right now. There's something about, like, what would happen?
Give me, like, a moan.
Like, just like, what would happen? Like, what would happen?
Jackie's literally covering her mouth over there.
What would the reaction be?
On the count of... I'm going to moan how I thought he was going to moan, okay? Yeah. I thought he was going to go,
oh.
Yeah. He went, ah.
No, I want to be like, I want to be getting fucking fucked when I do it. You know? Like he stepped on a tack or something. Like, ah. You know, fucking step on
You don't
want
to moan. You want to like
step
shriek.
On a Lego. Yeah. Yeah. I want to step on a Lego. Yeah, yeah. Squeal,
oh
really.
God. Squeal. Yeah, you want to squeal like a little piggy getting fucked. Yeah. Wow. Dude, why? What do you think this is?
I don't know, man. It's just been something that's been
Are
going
you
on.
Getting fucked at home? Is
no,
something going on?
No,
are you not getting
no,
fucked at home?
No, it's just an urge to want to, like, disrupt normal behavior.
What's really funny about that story is that you're telling it to Trent.
Right.
Who is, like, the last guy in the world that
well,
I think can
and then
relate
this,
to, like,
this,
sexual moaning.
This might... Listen to this. This hasn't come out yet, but this was just me the other day.
What do you think about that? No?
Hold on.
I like that. Talk to me.
Make me squirt.
I'm gonna...
I just told Lurch to make me squirt on the golf course. Like, I was like, just make me squirt. Like,
you're out of control,
I'm out of control right now.
You are out
that
of
That was
control.
2 months ago, so I don't know.
You
I've
are.
On a fucking bender.
You're on a horny bender. You're just on a bender of horniness.
But it's like, yeah, it's weird, dude.
Yeah, I'd say so. This is why I wanted to have you. When we started to have this idea of having a Barstool person on our Thursday episode every week. I think we've done it like once out of like the last 4 weeks.
Yeah. That's about how our ideas go.
Yeah.
We'll get there.
But you were like, it was basically like, we need to have Frankie back on and then maybe we'll keep it rolling. Because Frankie always delivers.
Fuck, man.
I'm also happy you're here. We will be doing the Bert Kreischer ballroom.
Oh, I can't wait.
Yeah.
We went to see Segura last night and Kevin was showing the picture around like Segura's dressing room. And he's like, are you showing everybody? And Kevin was like, I'm not showing him yet. So like, everyone was looking at me like, oh! And I was just sitting in the corner like a fucking loser, be like, I want to see
everyone,
that dude's testicles.
And everyone's had a different reaction. Some people have moaned and shrieked. Some
I
people
can't
have
wait,
just been
dude.
Pure confusion.
When are we doing that? Because I need to be mentally prepared.
Should we just get into it?
Yeah.
Well, let's talk a little.
I think I'm my tooth.
First of all, I know you say you don't, but when are you scheduling your second arm surgery? Because... You got like 3 days out of major elbow surgery and then played 2 rock concerts.
Yeah, it was officially.
Which I think, short of throwing a baseball and just getting, and like UFC, I think what you were doing is probably the worst thing you could be doing.
You know
what
was the worst so far that actually hurt me the most was writing. I wrote something and something about.
No, that's more just, than the drumming?
Yeah, because there's something.
Was that pre or post drumming?
This was post-drumming.
I think that's the straw that broke the camel's back.
Okay, okay.
I think that was like, we can't do anything ever again.
So I actually...
Are you jerking off?
I got a car accident. You know what hurt the most? Walking afterwards.
Yeah, right. It wasn't the walking. You can jerk off fine?
The first 2 weeks I couldn't. I was I was trying all different types of things. I was staring at it, just waiting for it to leak. just like, maybe
like
I
with
could...
with the force?
Like, yeah, maybe I could just bring it up and just out and just fucking watch it go. Fucking...
Oh man!
I'm trying to find a place for it to land. It like goes past my family.
Were you going lefty?
Fucking come!
I
couldn't
do
it.
You can't
do
lefty. Lefty's tough.
Dude, people who say that shit when they're like, "Oh, I just do the stranger. I like jerk off the other hand and feel." That's the fucking biggest lie ever told. Like when you jerk off the other hand. I mean, I've gotten it done before.
I've gotten myself there and then like 9/10 of the way and then finished lefty.
There's a reason why it's like the stranger because like it doesn't feel normal.
No,
like,
it doesn't feel normal. But I've gone the whole because I'm a lefty, so I'm righty. I've gone the whole way.
Yeah,
but like it's because like my left hand was broken.
Right.
Like,
you know what I've never realized about you guys? You're not a lefty, are you? You're lefty?
No, I'm actually dominant hand righty, but I do everything lefty. I golf lefty, swing lefty.
So then aren't you dominant hand lefty?
No.
Because I'm
dominant hand lefty.
You write righty.
I do everything right.
I'm like the baseball player that plays first base that he throws righty, but he plays, he bats lefty.
Yeah,
it's like a lot of power hitters for some reason do that. I wasn't one of those.
Switchy thing. Frankie, yeah. What I've never realized for you guys is that your whole life you spend shaking hands with your offhand.
No,
I'm a
dominant.
Well,
yeah, me, yes. Me,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, lefties,
so maybe,
yeah.
If you're mixing and matching. But if you're just a pure lefty, like, if I were to shake hands lefty, I would feel weird. That's right. How you guys always feel?
But that's why, no, because, like, I...
You just have to learn that way.
I'm, like, kind of, like, it's... I'm not ambidextrous. I'm not, like, a switch hitter and like that.
Right.
But I'm more ambidextrous than you are.
Well, most lefties are, like, mix and match a little bit.
Yeah.
It's very... few, like, I do
like, I throw
lefty.
Righty, I shoot righty,
because
I swing righty.
Because it's also like, you know, you're on the play, not the playground, but like, there's a bunch of fucking hockey sticks, like, you just gotta play righty.
Yeah,
there's
yeah.
a set of golf clubs, you gotta play righty, so you're kind of forced to do
scissors
it.
Scissors were the biggest one.
Scissors are
scissors
tough.
Or desks, you motherfuckers with your desk, you don't understand how good you had it.
The connected thing.
What are you even writing for you?
Like, I had this, oh, right, I mean, this hand was just
listen,
floating.
The lefties are despicable, they walk away with a pencil and ink all over.
Do you ever think about how crazy that is? Like, my parents, probably not quite my parents, but like, people whose parents are a little bit older, like, they were beaten.
Yeah.
They were beaten in school because they wrote with their left hand.
Were they?
Yeah. If you didn't, like, learn how to write, they just bash your fucking knuckles.
In, like, the Catholic school?
Yeah, I think it was, like, regular. Can we get a research on, like, when they stopped assaulting children who were left-handed?
That's crazy.
Like,
I don't think I knew that.
It was very recent.
You ever see the list of lefties that...
It's like brilliant people, right?
It's all the brilliant people in the world.
Yeah.
Like, every brilliant person on the planet was
lefty.
There's
a couple exceptions.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Dude,
the list is insane. It's like Mozart, Beethoven, it's fucking
Albert
crazy.
Einstein.
Albert Einstein.
Yeah,
the list is insane.
I mean,
they used to, like, tape your left hand behind your back and be like, go out into the world without your dominant hand until you... Like, they're Spartan children who are going to get thrown off mountains if they didn't learn how to be, right, in cursive in their left hand.
How do you finger people?
How do I finger people?
Righty,
I go both.
Or lefty?
I'll hit both.
Yeah?
Yeah, you'll catch it both angles.
Sometimes if I'm lefty and I need to, like, get the job done, and my forearms burn.
That's,
you know,
how I got
I'm
elbow
like,
surgery.
Yeah.
The thing was popping out.
It started in the 80s.
Started in the 80s or ended in the 80s?
It's beating children in the 80s?
No, dude, it had to have been earlier than that.
It couldn't have started in the 80s.
Oh, they started in, like, the fucking, you know, when as soon as there were lefties and there were adults and children, they were getting beat.
When did left-handed stop being punished? Like, what an outrageous concept!
That truly is nuts. That has to be a Catholic nun thing.
No, before the 70s, this person went to school and wasn't beaten for righty-lefty.
Sign of the devil.
Like... Bro, the things that we thought in such recent memory,
dude,
is
scary.
How about how we were like, oh my God, like the Taliban, those crazy fundamentalists, like, but send your kids to Catholic school where they used to think that if you were lefty, you were the devil.
Yeah.
You're just as fucking crazy as anything else in this goddamn world.
I wonder what we're doing right now.
I like how we just
turned
that into a defense of the
100
years. Taliban.
I say this all the time, and I also say, what do you think you're doing right now that in 100 years, like when your grandpa like drops a racial slur and you're like, well, he's 90.
Right.
What are we saying right now that they're gonna be like, can you believe they, like, probably gay. We still say gay a little bit. That'll probably really be like offensive by the end of it when it's all said and done.
The way you say it.
I think that I got two. Both are pretty controversial, I think.
Here we go.
One, I think eating meat. I think there will be a time where, like, the Beyond Meat gets so good. I think people will be like, you should just fucking eat
animals. Yeah, actually just, like, slaughter animals.
Yeah.
I could see that in hundreds.
But,
that one's probably not my lifetime.
Yeah.
But, like, maybe if I live to, like, 100. If it happened in 100 years, it wouldn't shock me.
John, let's not plan for 100, bud.
Yeah. I'll take care of that one.
Jar!
I'm like,
Jar!
What is it in World War Z? I'm the fucking Zeke. Don't worry, boys. I got this one. and I think there might be a time where they're like, you guys just used to fuck one sex.
Right.
Fuck everybody.
Right. Yeah. You didn't suck dicks also.
Totally. I agree with both those, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I do.
Those are good ones.
Because you can see the trend. Obviously, we're at the beginning of both of those.
It's more on the internet than anywhere else. But the internet's eventually it's a virus that's going to spread to everybody.
I think we're just going towards one thing, like, you know, it'd also be like, oh, girls had long hair and boys had short hair, or like names, like all that shit.
Totally.
I think we're just going to be one fucking, I meant to talk about this, you might actually like this. Because you get weird, right? When Frankie's brain starts going about like semi-serious things, he starts moaning and shit. He loses it. But I watched a 30-minute YouTube the other day.
I think I say porn. I was gonna say that's fucking. I take intermissions in my porn.
Yeah. But I've done full features.
Totally, dude. I watched Squid Game porn the other day.
What?
Ooh, yeah, it's fucking awesome, dude.
What?
I'm sure I can find
it's fucking awesome.
Damn, what was it?
It was like literally looked like Squid Games, and they did the red light, green light, 1, 2, 3, and then when the girl ran, the guy came over and just fucked her. It was fucking awesome.
Wait, can you watch a porn like that? Are you watching that to come, or are you watching that for entertainment?
I don't even know if I want to answer that question.
Was it animated or real life?
Real life.
Was it called Squirt Game? Because that's an easy layup.
Nah, so it was like a clip.
By the way,
of,
a lot of
red
them.
Light, green light, 1, 2. It was no.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's wow. That's a lot to handle. But where was it, dude? That was deep on Reddit.
Was it Pornhub?
Oh yeah. No. Oh, God, you're okay. A Reddit
guy. It was deep on Reddit somewhere.
Frankie goes to the dark web where people the only like a part of the internet reserved only for stealing credit card numbers. Frankie goes to find his points.
Exactly.
It's like, hey, can anyone help me hack my mom's credit card so I can buy Taliban flags?
Let's see.
I mean, here's something.
Yeah, there it is. That's it, dude. That's okay. Fucking awesome.
This was described as I downloaded a very wrong Squid Game video.
Dude, it looks just like it, man. The production value's off the charts. Look at this. Oh, wait. The CGI is unmatched. Look at this. Oh, come down. Yup.
Wow. Awesome.
So, is this? I don't think I have the answer to my question.
I hope they kill her.
No, I think
this is not an American porn.
No. I don't know why there's no volume.
It's a Reddit problem. Sometimes you have to hit the top link, the red gift. Yeah.
Again?
Sometimes if you click on that, right? Sometimes you gotta hit this little like, well, where why are you you gotta be like in the app.
Okay.
Yeah, I have the app.
Okay.
And you gotta sometimes click because does it have? Gifts, I mean, and then the red gifts has audio.
It's gotta have.
Know what I'm talking about.
It's gotta have the.
I'm not gonna leave you out to dry. I know what you're talking about.
I think I can do it with the Reddit app, but it's gotta have the music, right?
Yeah. So I think
that music is. I swear to God, I would say like 20% of Squid Game's like success. I think is that music. I think that sound, that repetitive.
Yeah.
That,
yeah.
Yeah. Was like a huge part
of
it.
At the end of that clip, they actually animate their own Squid Game logo. I couldn't read it because it's in like Chinese Korean or something, or Korean. But I mean, the money that was put into this thing is unreal.
Yeah, this is this is awesome.
I gotta be honest, the video I watched, doesn't look like some outrageous big budget Hollywood movie. It seems like a pretty standard porn.
Even have it.
This isn't even a full one.
Like, I don't know where they got the money to put up that graphic at the end.
It's legit a wall painted. It's a painted wall. That's it.
Oh shit.
Look at this thing. Look at the fucking production value. This is crazy.
Hilarious. This video doesn't have sound. This.
You get the full experience.
Let me get back to that.
Oh, fuck. Whatever. The thing is.
But yeah, that's great. But you know what I always think about?
Wait, so what video did you watch on YouTube?
Hang on.
Okay.
When you do like a porn parody, like what's in it for you? Like, that's something like we would do almost, you know? Like, let's make a Squid Game like spoof for Barstool so we get some more views. Are they doing that for like their porn page?
They're doing it for the views on the people that want to see like their favorite shows and the people get fucked. Like Friends and
but
like,
you know, like so there's some Pornhub account or whatever, Reddit account that's like, I'm just trying to get these views, man. I just want to get more subscribers or whatever.
Totally.
Yeah, it's just funny.
It's them
to
being
think.
Like unique and trying to like
I get it when it's like a couple or like a person.
Or like The Office. You want to see like fucking
Scott
and Pam and shit.
But when it's like vivid pictures or whatever.
Wait, you watch The Office porn?
I'm saying if you wanted to.
Well, you just said it's fucking awesome.
It probably is.
It is.
Yeah, I've typed in like my shows and
have you really?
On Reddit,
bro,
man.
See,
there's a whole Reddit page.
I'm going to come. I'm not going. I'll watch Netflix when I'm done. But like, I'm going. Like, I want to see something despicable, and then I want to finish, ejaculate, if you will,
and B, and then I can go out, I'll go lay on the couch, and I'll, sometimes I won't even get off the couch to begin with. Then I'll go lay on the couch and I'll put on my TV.
I've gotten way too dark and deep where I need to be like entertained now. Like it needs to be legitimate, up to production value. I need the whole
thing. See, but you've gotten so dark and deep that like you've come out off the other end.
Yes.
Where nothing, it's like now it's works. Like I want, like you're watching Jim and Pam make love. And it is like the most twisted thing. you're like, kiss her, dude.
Kiss her, I watch Jim, I'll watch
her,
it all.
Hold her hand through the parking lot. Propose, yeah. Oh, God, yeah.
Fucking Family Guy.
Porn, oh, I could see.
You watch Family Guy porn?
I'm saying I could if I want.
What
you know?
Do you think about the cartoon porn?
Love it.
Yeah.
The noises. Dude, that's out of shit, dude. I mean,
look how big this chick's dick is.
Oh, my God, dude.
Look at that. And you can't really hear it because I was like recording off my computer, but like the flops.
Yeah.
Are just
the flops are nuts.
Just good, man. Wow. So I mean, good. This
look how
is
big this chick's dick.
Yeah.
Talking about a fucking now I will
look how tiny her waist is, how big her tits are, and how big her dick is. Look how long her balls are hanging up. Yeah.
Oh man.
Look at those things.
Look at those balls.
Those balls are right. Whacking.
So having not seen Bert's balls, that's like my balls.
You can see when you're fucking
my
a
balls
girl,
swing. My balls swing.
Do they hit?
Yes.
If I'm fucking a girl in the ass, I can hit her clit with my balls. on a certain day, you know? Like, always. Yeah. Sometimes they're armadillo. Again,
I've had sex in a hockey parking lot before. No one was getting hit with swinging
nuts
that day.
Yeah, those nuts are tight. But if it's a hot day and I'm swinging, it's like your balls are on my clit.
I got a buddy who's got two just absolute coconuts. It's a problem.
Are they injured or something?
No,
or
dude. And he always whips them out because it makes everyone just laugh out loud at how insane they are. It's like a little mini hot dog resting on the top of two flesh balls. Just like a little
how
fucking.
He can pee on his balls.
If he wants to.
That is tough.
It's crazy, dude.
That is tough.
Yeah. All balls, no dick. It's a horrible life.
Does it fit in like boxers and sweatpants and stuff?
It's just spilling out.
Are they like swollen? Are they like, dark?
Yeah.
They're swollen and like red and just fucking huge.
That is a bad life.
That's one of those things too. I feel like having swollen balls is like having like when you bite your lip.
Because
now it's in the way, so now it just keeps getting hit.
Everything's in the way.
And what would you rather have? Swollen. Cauliflower ears or swollen balls?
Swollen balls for sure, man. Cauliflower is horrendous.
I think like if it's not that bad, cauliflower.
Well, no, I'm talking both ears are swole up shut, you know?
Like, what's that, Ben Askren or whatever his name is? It's
yeah,
like
all
two
those
holes
guys.
In his head.
I think that you can spin cauliflower ears as like a cool thing. While it's objectively gross, I think right now MMA is having such a moment, and it's almost like a sign, like, don't fuck with me. Like, if you're a good-looking guy.
I don't know, man. It's just too gross. Swollen balls in some circles are sick.
It's like
in what circles?
Like, oh,
apparently
like
Frankie's friend circle.
Got huge balls. Like that's it's a funny like party trick. Pulls them out, we go crazy. No one's going crazy for the cauliflower,
your
kid.
I could just picture Frankie being like, "Yeah, he did it. Yeah. He brought him out again."
Yes. That's exactly funny. What we do.
I knew a bunch of kids, a bunch of animals who went to Chaminade. You know Chaminade. Yeah.
Weird school,
and they're the weirdest kids, man. Yeah. All my friends are from Chaminade. I make fun of them incessantly. It's just. What's the old joke? Why there are no stairs in Chaminade? Because fairies know how to fly or something like that.
Oh, you know what ours was in school? I'm not gonna say it.
Oh God, hard F words.
Yep. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. It was it was against BC High, and you know it.
No. Well, maybe.
BC High, BC Low. That's where all.
Yep.
That, not gonna finish it, but there was a lot of gay stuff going on in middle school.
Well, these guys were just total animals, and when the last Pope was elected, or I guess maybe two popes ago, they were in high school, and they just went nuts for it. Like they were like standing, like just to fuck around.
Oh, that's
like,
kind of
like,
awesome.
Like the teacher came in and was like. Like, gentlemen, we have white smoke, you know, pipe, Pope Benedict or whoever it was has been. And my one friend, Andrew, like, stood up on the, and this guy's like a gorilla to begin with. He stood up on the desks and was like, "New Pope! New Pope!" And, like, flipping desks and going wild just because, like, you know.
The championship in their world.
Yeah, I mean, it was just like dumb Catholic school boys going bananas. All right, you want to do the balls? Or you want to do my YouTube video? They're two very different roads. Because the YouTube shit I watched was like,
let's do the YouTube. Okay. Because we already started
really,
that. And like,
this was a really I don't know how I saw this. But I saw a tweet that said, this is the most profound moment in gaming history.
Oh, wow.
What was that? And then I opened it up and it was a YouTube account that was like, this might be the most profound moment in like media history. Did you ever play the game Metal Gear?
Yeah, I think
Metal
so.
Metal Gear Solid?
Yeah.
Yeah, Metal Gear Solid.
With Snake?
Yes. But this was Metal Gear Solid 2 with a guy named Raiden. And anyway, at the very end, you win, but at the very end, you find out that you were like a puppet. And the general who was ever giving you orders was actually artificial intelligence. This shit came out in the year 2000 and predicted everything from like cancel culture to fake news to misinformation.
And the
basic premise was that humans are too stupid to basically know what's important and what's not important to pass down to the next generations. So we're just getting stupider and stupider and focusing more and more on the wrong things and getting like radicalized and like the way that people get like hardcore for their political parties.
Yeah.
Like people are digging their heels in. They'd rather die than admit that they're wrong, and that you need something to like to sift out what's like worthy of learning and what's not. So like they're still kind of the bad guys in the end because they're talking about censorship. They're like, we'll tell you what you should and shouldn't know.
This is all inside the game?
And this is at the end of a video game.
What is happening?
Yeah, it's like the two little people, like there's two heads talking and there's like words just popping up in the middle like a video game.
Holy shit.
And it's like, you know, the good guy is like, you're not gonna censor me, like I have free will. And the guy's like, you're too stupid for free will. And it was in the year 2000. And it predicted like all of this shit. And so at the end, it was kind of like, yeah, censorship's bad. But I was kind of like, if you told me that there was like a computer system that was like, will sift out the dumb stuff and then tell you the good stuff, I'd be like, I trust that more than the dumb people of the world.
Yeah, I'm pro censorship.
Yeah, I was kind of like, this is like I was listening to the bad guy in the video game, and like, I was like,
Kevin,
this guy's making a lot of points.
There should be someone out there being like, this podcast shouldn't go out.
There should
be someone in control. Someone should be like, that guy doesn't need a microphone.
We should honestly have like a disclaimer. Like enough people listen to our podcast that like if we ever heard about them putting certain things into practice, I'd be like, don't listen to us.
Totally,
you know.
And my one or two appearances on this within a year just ruin everything about me. Like I talk for 5 minutes on this show and it's over. I'm getting denied
houses.
That's
what I love about
this show. I can't even get fucking bank loans. Like, were you on KFC Radio? we can't trust this fucking guy. I'm sitting there and like,
you go on KFC Radio, you ruin your credit.
I'm sitting there in like a tie and he's like, did you say that you want to get your asshole spat in so much that it actually comes out of your mouth and you turn into the fucking water fountain at the mall?
Did you say that you like your porn so hardcore you need to squeegee the ground to push the blood
like
into the sewers?
Like the Box Cutters episode.
Yeah, people.
Frankie was disappointed in the Squid Game porn.
Yeah,
there's not enough blood. Yeah, people might not know that. Frankie's like, I always forget that we've been doing this long enough, and there's a lot of new listeners.
That's the old office.
Frankie said that like the episode in Breaking Bad where Gus cuts his henchman's neck with a box cutter and the blood pours all over their meth lab, and Frank and Jesse and Walter need to squeegee the blood into like the vents on the ground, the sewer. He said, I want my porn to be like that.
So my porn sets need vents on the floor.
Do your family ever hear those things that
probably,
you say?
Probably, dude. Yeah. I don't want to think about that.
Do you think that it's a lot of don't ask, don't tell in the Borelli family?
Huh?
Is there a lot of don't ask, don't tell in the Borelli family?
It's just like no one talks about any of that stuff with me, but then I'll hear like my dad walking the dog. He'll come in and he has the shows like playing on his phone on speakerphone. And I'm just like, what did I say in that episode? And then I hear it from across the house. I'm like, that's awkward. Yeah. Boy, that's awkward. And then we just go down and like share an orange juice and breakfast together. And it's just like, damn, dude. Damn, we ain't making pizzas anymore, Pop.
You ain't in Kansas anymore. We ain't in Borelli's anymore, Pops.
Man. He's sitting there, it's like, woof. Fuck.
We are that show, man. Woo. I mean, I remember Casey, Casey does a million shows, but her family, her dad and her mother, like, finally stumbled upon KFC Radio after she was doing CCK, and she was like, you cannot listen to that one.
Yeah, no.
And I was like, wow, we're really that one, huh? That's our show,
but
huh?
It's my fault, because it bleeds into Foreplay also. I talk about
this
all the time.
I love when Foreplay, both Foreplay and Chiclets, you guys do golf and hockey, great. I know why you do it. It's your specialization. It helps a lot with merch. Helps a lot with the audience. I know. All that shit. But both shows are so much better when you guys aren't talking about golf.
Bro, we talk about golf 10% of the time.
Yeah. When you're doing the hypotheticals, when you're doing the gross shit, it turns into a KFC radio episode, and you're so much better at
that. My anesthesia dick the other day.
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah. Go on.
You didn't hear about my anesthesia dick when I had my surgery?
Proceed. Yeah.
Fucking.
Was it hard?
No, dude, it was horrifying. I fucking go in for my elbow surgery. I'm all freaked out, like you're about to get put under, which to me is like a really nice feeling. You're about to go to sleep. Like,
love that last
second. The forceful
second.
Feeling of going to sleep is pretty cool.
Yeah.
It's still nerve-wracking. Like, in my head, I'm like, you're about to go to sleep right now. You're about to go to sleep right now. You're about to go to sleep right now. And then you go to sleep. It's a fucking weird feeling. So I get the surgery. I'm in the recovery room, and I'm like, for some reason, I was naked, like all the way down to my Tommy John boxers. I guess because of sterilization. Like, it's an elbow surgery. I'm like, why am I naked?
No, no, yeah, you got to be in the gown, and they take,
you're in the gown, though.
Yeah, I'm in a gown, like, I have my boxers on, and that's it, right? So I wake up, which to me felt like a second. You close your eyes, open them up, you're just now in another room. It's a weird feeling.
Bandaged up or whatever.
So I'm bandaged up, I'm looking around, I'm completely out of, like, I'm out of it. And this big nurse, this older lady, big woman, comes over and she's like, all right, sweetie, we got to get you up. We got to get you up and moving. And I was like, okay. So I get up and I look down and just disgusting, limp penile is hanging out of the little area. You know on Tommy John's where it can just slip out? You know the little pouch?
It's and got it's the just, quick draw fly.
Just this like pale head of a penis is just flopping around. And I looked at her and she shrieked. She went, woo! And I was like, oh, like
your
looking around like,
really working to put it back
I
in,
was like, oh, she goes, put yourself together, sweetie. And I was like, just like the most disgusting penis she's ever seen in her entire life.
You made a medical professional streak in your penis.
Dude, it was gray. It was, you know what I mean? Like it was
like an
like
alien.
A, it looked
like an alien head.
It looked, yeah, it was an alien head.
It looked like defrosted meat from the freezer.
Oh, God.
I hadn't moved in 3 hours. I'm laying there. It slipped out, like slithered out.
I mean, that's as soft as you can get,
oh,
right?
God,
like,
dude, it was
like you're,
so
no,
bad.
Legitimately, though, like your injured body is like, you know, you're not turned on.
No,
your body's not worried
no.
about your dick at all.
No.
You're like keeping your blood as tight as possible.
I was
going
to say, your
else.
Body's like, we just lost a bunch. We have no blood to spare.
We need blood in our
right
brain,
now.
Our blood in our heart. We're not giving it to the dick right now.
You look at an alien, just like a dead alien, like found in the desert. Looked like fucking Voldemort.
Yeah.
So my anesthesia dick was probably the worst feeling I've ever had about myself.
You're the color of like a dolphin.
Yeah.
Like a stingray.
Yeah, exactly.
Dolphin's
a beluga whale.
I think a dolphin's a little too vibrant, Ray. Like it's a more
Seattle.
It's a Seattle dust.
Yeah, you need something that's not reflective, like a dull gray. Yeah. You know, because the dolphins are slick and shiny. You need something that's just blah.
Wow. Yeah,
gray flesh dick.
Ugh.
That poor nurse. And nurses, I mean, dude, nurses like
they
wipe asses. They deal with ugly vaginas. They cut people open. They go up assholes. They took just a look at your regular penis and were like, ah!
I think the way it slithered out was the shock factor.
It was like,
woo!
Like a snake. Just
yeah,
like,
it was
bah.
Bad. It was bah. Bad. Yeah, it literally was like,
bah! Tongue. Bah! Yeah. All right, well, while we're talking about ugly genitals, it's time. So just to recap for like the fourth episode in a row, I'm a big fan of Bert Kreischer. He's done the show a couple times. He gave me his number once. We've only texted a couple times here and there. Cause and I say that to explain, like, if I texted Chris DiStefano right now, like, show me that dick pic, he would do it.
Yeah.
If I text Josh Wolf right now, you know, Josh Wolf's got them all on deck, you know. Certain guys I've become very friendly with. Bert, I'm just like professionally friendly with. But close enough and funny enough that I was like, I want to see this picture of your balls. Because on his episode, he said, I have like the longest balls in the world. Me and John often talk. John sits on his balls all the time. I talk about mine swanging like a grandfather clock. Like I was like, I got to see this. And I texted him, just get ghosted. Just left on red, me texting another grown man about his balls.
Horrifying.
Luckily, Tom Segura comes into the office just last episode. And Tom is able to deliver the picture. I got the picture the night after Tom was on the show, and I've been sitting on it since. Sitting on it. because I was like, I want to do this on the air. And I mean, it's like having a present to show somebody. You know what I mean?
I can't imagine what these things look like.
So, and for reference, Bert is on his bus. He was going like down the aisle, and so he had his pants down for some reason. So he's backing up. Okay. With his nuts out. So you're basically about to see, like, in the movie Waiting, when Dane Cook, when they talk about the goat.
Yeah.
I think this is the goat, right? This is, or the brain. No, this is the goat.
The goat.
You're about to see the goat.
Okay.
But just in a horrifying way. Now, you want me to just, like, show
just
it
show
like this?
Show me the okay. fucking nuts, dude.
Just show me the nuts. All right. All right. All right. It's so good, dude.
How could they,
it's totally gonna
how could
deliver.
They be so crazy.
It's they're so long, and the part that it's connected to, it's just staggering. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Bert's balls. Does it not look like a penis and balls? It looks like a penis and balls, doesn't it?
Dude, what the fuck?
That looks like a dick.
Dude, they almost go down to the bend in his knee.
Yes. That's his knee.
Oh my god.
That looks like a dick and balls fucking him in the ass.
Bro,
but it's
what
just his balls
fuck?
And like his tube. That's his dick tube, you know? You know your dick tube goes from your dick all the way back to
no,
your butt?
That's just his
that's
fucking,
his tube.
No.
How could that be his
that's,
tube?
That's his nutsack.
That's
how could
mean.
That be his tube?
That's his.
You're telling me that's the base of his dick right there?
No.
No, 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 no. No. That's like his taint. I don't know what it is.
Hey.
Dude, it looks like he's being fucked.
I've seen it. It looks like a dildo.
That looks like a dildo with balls going up into it.
That's not normal.
That's definitely
that's abnormal. I've seen it.
You're telling me you can contend with this?
On a long ball day, I might have a puncher's chance.
No yeah. way.
Well, you know what that means. Like, on your next long ball day, you're going to have to do this.
We're going to have to do it, yeah.
And I'm gonna,
you
I'm
have
gonna
a chance at that?
I feel like I do, man. I feel it. I feel like, dude, I haven't been talking game.
Look how far back they're, like, coming around his...
Like, that's insane!
It's not just, like, in his crack.
Bro,
his legs.
No, zoom out.
It's
zoom
like
out.
Here.
When you see his whole body, that's insane, man. He looks like
but he's a little crouched down. All right, so I'm just trying to fucking figure it out here. He's a little... I cannot look at Jackie while I do this. I'm just going to stare at the wall. It, like,
no,
he's a
John,
little...
There's no chance.
He's a little crouched, dude, down. If you had a little hang, I think... If,
bro,
if we're talking mid-quad with a crouch, I could be in the...
That's look, not mid-quad.
That's
like
mid-quad.
That's like knee,
crouch,
dude.
Nah,
no, mid...
down here.
Mid is like there, where like the top of his balls are. That second ball bottom is another, like... 3 inches
I'll,
lower.
Can I make another
insane.
Confession right now?
Uh-huh. Oh, boy.
For my entire life, until basically right now,
oh, God.
I thought I had an undescended testicle because my nut's like that, where I got like one
on
higher nut,
the other?
One
well,
lower.
That's also...
I was like, I've always been like, I think I have undescended testicles. I've just shut my mouth about it.
Well...
Should I not have said that?
Can I take that one back?
Yeah. Are you telling me Bert also has an undescended testicle? Because I have nuts like Bert.
This guy has
your
a
nuts are totally like.
Yeah, they're symmetrical.
Yeah, I think
yours are too.
I think so.
All right, we got one.
Yeah, I think that mine's like a, but not like that.
Mine
this
are,
is unhealthy, dude.
Mine are closer
Bert's,
to
Bert's,
that than symmetry.
Bert's are on top of
when
each
mine
other.
Are when mine are hanging and banging.
They're that
fucking
way?
Like that. There's a stark disparity.
Like two marbles
also,
hitting each other.
Yeah. Because that also
it's
gives
a, what's
you
what's that thing called? The dung dung.
Yeah.
Just keep going back and forth.
Yeah. You. That will give you some length because you have another ball.
Yeah, it's pulling
you know,
the
like,
down
like,
to
like
the
my
depths
balls
of hell
are this
with
low,
it.
But your balls are this low because you have another one.
Also,
bottom.
His like
I have one nut that's just been fucking snipped. So it's just hanging, it's just bouncing around that bag solo. And then it's just
there's nothing connecting. Like if you were to cut the skin, it would just fall out.
Yeah, it's like
your balls right now is a wet brown bag of groceries, and it's wet at the bottom, and like an orange could just fall out the bottom. It could just rip and fall out. There's nothing connecting you to that bag.
Bro, I am relieved, scared. Entranced. I am feeling so many
challenge.
Things.
You're ready to compete,
his
brother.
His tube is smooth, too.
Smooth, too. Shout out Manscaped. Promo code KFC.
But like, just like you would think with that much hang for that many years that it would be like
wrinkly or
wrinkled
or
and like it's like stretched and weathered. That thing's smooth, man. What's going on there?
I also
bro?
Just don't get that. That looks like a head. That looks like a tip of a dick.
No, I don't get it.
I don't get it at all.
I'm gonna be thinking about. I can't
be thinking about this forever.
You
look
better get
lines.
Ready to get a lot of pictures of my balls.
Does he?
Yeah.
Does he get to like add those inches on to his dick size?
Yes.
Yeah, definitively, yes.
And guess who's got a 15-inch dick now?
You know what I've just visualized here, too? I visualize, like, I'm an island boy. It's like, what are those lines? What is that? Like, all of those creases and cracks and shit. That looks like a jester. That looks like a court jester.
No, his grunt looks like the state of Texas, bro.
You got to start.
That's his nose. That's his mouth.
Hey, baby, you want to take a trip down to the Lone Star State? That is Bert's nutsack is the Bermuda Triangle. You get lost in that shit.
You get lost in here.
You're going to see some stuff that scares you and you're never coming back out.
Bro, that, like,
you guys have to have a nut off, like, in person.
Yeah.
I love that.
But it depends. I got to have the right day, you know?
Well, that's the thing. This might be, like, every day for
Bert. If that's how Bert wakes up, if that's a day.
And I woke up like this. I mean,
Then maybe he's got me. But, like, if we're having fucking nut, like, if we can fucking compare nut day picks and nut day picks, I think, again, I don't want to, Bert's Tyson, okay?
Yeah. You might be Buster Douglas.
Landed one.
Yeah. You might.
Oh my God. It's like when you're at the grocery store and you have two kiwis in those plastic bags and they're just fucking walking up. You just want like one or two kiwis. And you feel like you have a huge ball sack in your hand. That's exactly what he had.
So I showed this to a girl and I forgot to tell her that he was backwards.
Bro, if he
so
bends
his knee.
So she
thought this was forward and she goes, where's his penis?
She's still one big pussy in the front.
It looks like he has a pussy. Like, you could fuck that hole, it seems like.
The ones, where you can't see any of the pussy. It's just the whole thing is covered.
It's crazy. It's also crazy that we've been doing this for, like we did this whole segment. We've been doing it for 3 weeks. Imagine if this was just, like, I was like, look at Whitney Cummings' pussy, dude. Like, we're just objectifying Bert Kreischer's ball sack for a week for our content. And fun. Nothing. And guess what? We have Bert on the show coming up.
I was going to say.
We have him in studio this Saturday.
I think you're going to see him in the flesh. Like,
Balls. I don't know about in the flesh. I mean, you think he'll show us his balls in real time? Mm-hmm. Yeah, that would be cool.
That'd be a moment.
I think we all have to show each other. We have to have a moment.
It's
going to
be a whole ball off. Yeah.
Jackie, stay home that day.
Yeah. Jackie might have to go, like, out, you know, like, go outside the room, like, for the extra.
That's not, like, attractive, right? Like long balls down to the kneecap?
No.
Okay. Definitively no. Okay. I feel like balls are just cool something thing. That girls girl. Have to put up with, right?
Yeah.
I think even dicks are. Jackie goes, yeah. I think dicks are just like, we'll tolerate it because like it kind of can give us pleasure, but not really. But like, you know, that sucks. That sucks for girls. I guess I'm not like, it's not like when I see a pussy, I'm like, oh, that like looks, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like, ooh, that's
like none
hot.
Of the none of the genitals are really that good of a situation.
No.
But yeah, like, girls can make it like presentable. Guys,
that's why I've always been off oysters. I'm like, this is fucking. I can't fuck this. I'm not gonna.
What?
Oysters look like pussies. Oysters look like pussies. They're even shaped like pussies.
What pussy are you?
Oysters look like pussies. That's not even.
One of those blue waffle
pussies. It's an alien
pussy.
It's not a human pussy. It's a gray pussy. It's a post-surgery anesthesia pussy.
Like an open pussy? Like
a fucking
oyster?
Open puss.
Oh, open oyster?
Bro, this is not going to be my fucking bags of sand moment. I've seen pussies before.
I don't think you have.
I don't know.
Why do vaginas look like oysters?
John, this looks like a pussy to you?
I said alien pussy, but
show me the pussy. Describe the pussy,
dude. What are you talking?
Show me where the pussy is.
This is the.
And I'm not. And I'm not gonna.
Those are just oysters.
I'm not gonna let one asshole on Reddit who doesn't know what a pussy looks
find
like.
Find the one. Look, there's the clit up top. Bam, clit up top. Fucking
okay,
gray pussy on lips on the outside.
There. I saw a pussy there.
Yeah, you can see puss there. There's fucking puss in that
right
pit.
There, that's a pussy.
Well, that's a puss.
The clit I get. Yeah. The rest is just a bad pussy.
No, it's a fucking oval-shaped thing with a clit. That's a puss.
Woo!
So, you know what, girls? Stop complaining about it.
I fucking told you that was going to be my bag of sand moment.
Don't complain about dicks and balls, girls, because you got oyster pussies, okay?
Oyster puss, and it smells like it, too.
Isn't it so funny?
It actually does. I don't know where that came from. I don't know if I've ever fucked a pussy that was like, this smells like fish.
Good for you, man.
Yeah, you have?
There was one girl.
I've tasted pennies before. I've had copper puss, sure.
Everybody,
fish
puss? Every girl's pussy tastes like copper, unless it's
copper
like
pennies. Yeah.
It tastes like pennies. I mean, if you lick a penny, you've tasted a pussy. Yeah. Like vice versa. If you're like a virgin, and you don't know, lick a penny. You are, and then you are ready for oral sex with a girl. I feel like I have, you know, not like fish, but, you know, not, hasn't been pleasant.
Yeah, like
I
little,
knew a guy who.
A little salt on it? Like
yeah,
that.
Like, yeah, there's some, there's just something, you know
hey,
what it is?
Hey, babe, go for a run around the block a few times.
Oh.
You'll put salt on your food? What are you talking about?
Yeah. I knew a guy who hooked up with a girl in the backseat of a car in Cancun. Her pussy was so bad, he was like going down on her, and he would throw up out the window of the car and then come back in and keep going. That's a bad vagina. You think you've had bad pussy? Have you ever thrown up out of the back seat of a car
and then dove back in
pussy? Have you ever had that bad of pussy? And have you ever been that desperate to get laid? Neither. Just leave it, dude. Just go home and jerk off.
He is in fucking war.
That is
thing.
Down bad.
Oh shit. Ugh.
I don't know how or when I'm going to do any ad reads on this show.
I just got a question. We can do. All right, I'll take it normal for a second because I had a little rant I had to go on.
Okay.
About last night.
Also, I think the funniest pussy story of all time.
Wait, let's finish this one.
Well, I don't know if anyone.
Man, we still got pussies out. There's some more juice in this one.
Little oyster juice. I don't know if this clamato out.
We may have to cut it because I don't know if it's public, but when. To go to the chiropractor because he ate too much pussy.
Yeah.
we'll
beep out the name if we have to.
I think that is the funniest fucking story I've ever heard in my entire life. Yeah. He ate so much pussy that he had to go see a chiropractor the next day. So the other day we see him, I'm like, what are you getting into this week? You're trying to see a chiropractor on Monday? It's the fucking best.
You're trying to have such a good Thursday, you go to the chiropractor on Monday?
Dude, we were talking.
And then as I understand it, the next morning, she still was like, get me out of here. Right?
Yeah.
So, like, if you eat so much pussy that your neck hurts and that girl is still waking up in the morning, like, this is the biggest regret of my life. You're either really bad at going down on girls or your company otherwise is horrendous.
Dude, he came walking into the office and he turned around like this. I'm like, what happened to you? Because I ate too much
neck
pussy.
Brace.
I ate too much pussy, dude.
Bro, I remember that episode.
He ate so much pussy. He couldn't even turn his head.
Bro, oh, I remember shit. That episode of Curb Your Enthusiasm. That episode of Curb with Larry's like, there's only two ways you hurt your neck, car accidents and cunnilingus. And I was like, what is he talking about? I've never hurt my neck eating pussy. I guess I've been eating pussy good enough, man.
I was
going to
say, you're not diving in there, dude.
I was trying to think, like, I was watching that show laying on the couch like a girl having girls' night where I was trying to be like, all right, how would I have to like fuck my neck up? I'm like,
could you imagine that moment? Do you think that for him it was like, like he woke up the next morning, or you think in the moment he was like he was digging in and then he was like, fuck.
Yeah,
like
he was Greg Jennings. Put the team on his back. Like, just, are you hurt or injured?
That was
fucking muck that barn.
That was his flu game.
I hope it happened.
He was diving in and he felt like a pinched nerve. He's like, oh, I got a
guy
finish.
In the pizza review where he threw his back up.
No. Great pizzas. Here. No. Take a slice. Take a slice. You want a slice?
I think he just threw out his back.
Do you throw your back? You got spaz. Pizza cure spaz. Are you all right?
It's too dangling.
Flop. That's New York.
And I gotta get two bags from my doorman to take upstairs.
Do you need help? You just had a back spasm.
I'll make it.
If you need help,
like
carry it.
I'll carry spasm.
I'm like a superhero of New York. I'll carry it. If you need help, I'll carry it.
Just keeps going. That guy is unbelievable too. What are the odds that we did a pizza review and the guy threw his back out in that one
on
little
camera.
1 second frame?
That yelp. That yeah.
He goes, oh, good pizza. Ha ha ho! He threw his back out. He laughed. He laughed himself into a back spasm. Oh God, all time.
We can do an ad read on that. You're gonna go out this weekend, have a good time. You gotta make sure you have Revitalyte on deck to make sure you fight through that hangover afterwards. You wake up, you got a busted neck, you gotta hit the chiropractor. You also gotta fight through all that dehydration and the bad taste in your mouth, the headache, all that. Revitalyte is the answer. Right now, you can get the blue bottle. It's the black label that Revitalyte partnered up with Barstool.
It's delicious.
Oh, there's one over there. Yeah.
Everybody knows when it comes to these drinks, blue is the flavor, the best flavor. And Revitalyte is the best way to fight through that hangover. I recommend that you drink this before you drink, during while you drink, like use it as your mixer, after you drink that night, and then have it on deck, ice cold for the morning, and that hangover can't compete. Four rounds of Revitalyte Black Label by Barstool Sports. You're going to do your best to fight it. No fruit juice in this. This is just loaded with electrolytes, carbohydrates. It's got some good flavoring. Great color. Great look to it. Black Label. It's Revitalyte, man. You can get it at the Barstool Sports store. You can get it. The best part, you used to have to go like get Pedialyte in the baby aisle. You're like crippled and hungover with your broken neck from too much activity. And there's a mom getting like diapers, and you're like, yeah.
It's so weird.
Now you don't have to worry about that at all. You can just get it right from the Barstool Sports store. And you can tweet at us at Drink Revitalyte. Show us your morning after stories, and we'll repost you with your Revitalyte tales. What do you got to rant about, buddy?
Oh, I forgot about it. Okay, now I'm hot again. Dude, so this is the thing I've run into. I probably tell more stories than most people, so I get it more often, I think. But I'm so sick of people on the internet not believing things.
Oh, yeah.
I'm done with it. Last night, I got legitimately rattled and triggered.
What tale were you telling last night?
It's the most believable, regular-ass fucking story. So here's what happened. It was after I left you. I split from you. In fact, I am going to tell people, and if you want to figure it out, if you can fucking, I didn't have my receipt, so people didn't believe me. But you want to call the West Side Market? I was on the 14th. I was on the 7th Avenue side, and it was my bill was $51.73. I will tell you everything I purchased. It was three boxes of cereal. It was French Toast Crunch. It was Special K Red Berries, and it was Frosted Mini Wheats.
I'll write you about like $15.
I got a roll, no more than that. It was two or seven each. One was five each, I think. Woo! So I need the picture at the top.
$7.
And then I also got a gallon of milk. I'm sorry, not a gallon, a half gallon of milk. It was 2%. It had a purple cap. And I got a roll of a loaf of farmhouse sweet Hawaiian bread.
Great, so as I was great choice.
Cereal, I was like, you know what?
I prefer the hearty white, but the sweet Hawaiian also fire. Sweet,
yeah. And then, so what's happening is, as I'm checking out, I was on the phone. I was like, I was hungry. I was kind of annoyed. I'd walked for a while. I'd been walking for an hour at that point.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was like, I just wanted to fuck out of there. And as I check out, I see an orange rolling on to my counter until like into my bag as the woman's bagging my stuff. And I was like, whatever. And I see two more limes come. And I was like, whatever. And a fucking six pack of beer comes. And I was like, what is going on? And the woman was like, she goes, is that yours? I was like, no, it's not mine. And she goes, together? And the dude behind me goes, I don't know this fucking guy. And I was like, dude, what? And then like there was kind of like this weird, quiet, like time. I'm on the phone, so I'm like, hang on one second. I'm trying to figure this fucking shit out. And then no one does anything. And the woman just hits purchase. And he's like complete, and I just fucking swiped it, and I went, "Yo, enjoy your beer," and walked out. And he's like, "Hey, hey, hey!" And I was like, I just kind of like made my hands, and he stormed out. And I sent a tweet that said,
"He paid for this guy's beer."
Yeah, I sent a tweet that said, "Where is
because he's Feitelberg." That is so believable. That's actually twofold believable.
It was. Tweet. I said, "Okay." Just went to buy some cereal at the market. Dude behind me put a six-pack right up there with my shit. No divider. I didn't say anything. Just paid for his beer and walked away because I'm a coward, and that's the whole story. Not that crazy. Dude. People are like, bull fucking shit, dude. That is, like, there's some confusion at the market. The fucking bag lady and the cashier register don't speak English. I was on the phone. I didn't feel like dealing with all this stuff. I was like, here's fucking $14. Let me get the fuck out of here. I don't care.
I also think it's believable because we know you're a coward. We've been talking about stories like this our entire careers here, how you'd rather like pay for something or lose money or whatever to avoid awkward confrontation. And also, if I'm in that spot and someone says something to me, like, I don't know this fucking guy and he's a dick, I'm going to try to big time him and be like, here's your fucking, here's your beer, fucking you peasants, beer, right. You know? And even though it's like, I'll show you, I'll give you free beer for the night. Like, I know that doesn't make sense, but in my mind, it does.
The six-pack of Shiner Bock.
Yeah.
So everything right. I've told you everything that was purchased. Yeah. Fucking call West Side Market. Do ask math. What that all costs with tax. I guarantee you, it's $51.73.
Bang.
Fuck you.
Who the fuck would make that up?
That's the other thing. Like that. Like to know all the details. To it's make crazy. All the stories. I also have said over the years, if some of these stories that we talk about are fake, then we should have like a show at Netflix of all time.
And like, and I get like some of the stories, like a story that recently has the cop, our live show November 12th at Gramercy Theater, get tickets. The cop who woke me up on a park bench in Mount Pelier is coming to the show. It's not 100%, but his kid is coming, and he thinks he's going to get his kid, his dad to come with him. That story, if you're like, oh, I don't know, I get it. Right. Okay, like, yeah. I cross international lines in that story. I smuggle drugs in that story. Right. Like, that story, like, this is a fucking... But people do it all the stories. All like everything. Like, oh, here's the deal. Either maybe I have a more interesting life than you, or I tell better stories.
Yeah, what
I and spoiler alert, it's both.
Yeah, I can't believe that, like, especially with the internet and social media and getting to like see the whole world, it's like, yo, people are fucking weird.
They're weird shit and they're fucking assholes.
Things happen. It's a bizarre fucking world.
Oh, those fucking guys. Who's that? Who's that asshole?
That's the kind
who
of
speaks
shit.
Like
he had,
that.
He had like a fucking like biker jacket and like a bag across his shoulder, and he had like fucking shaggy hair. And I guarantee he looked like a motorcycle biker. I guarantee you, motherfuckers, he was going to get on a bicycle outside that.
That's why I wish I could fight for moments like that,
dude. I wish I could have fought this fucking airline worker. Like, I really, I told
you, you're a worker,
airline attendant.
Oh, no, no, I just stopped hearing you. Airline.
What would you consider the
flight
person?
Attendant?
Yeah, but it's the person that you check in with.
Desk
fucking loser.
Yeah.
I told this a couple months ago in Foreplay, but I still think about it to this day.
Every day, I bet you do.
It was, you know, we live in a pandemic world right now, so you don't know what rules have changed and what rules haven't, and the airport's a fucking nightmare right now. So usually, when you buy a fucking plane ticket, if you're row 7, you're going to board before row 35, right? In a normal world.
Right.
So I'm walking through this airport. It's like 6 o'clock in the morning in San Francisco. We just got done with a fucking shoot for Foreplay. And I'm by myself. I'm going to another state. Everyone else is going to another state. Anyway, I have AirPods in my fucking head, so I'm not paying attention. I'm, like, tired. I don't want to be there. No one wants to be at the airport ever. I walk up to the gate. I hear them say, so I'm row, so I could be, if you went back and listened to the other, me tell it before, I could have the numbers wrong, but let's say I was row 14, right?
Mm-hmm.
I heard over the last week, rows 15 through 20 can now sit, right, and come board. So I'm like, oh, like I just missed your 10 through 14, I'm going to go up there. So I'm waiting online, I'm standing there, and I go to scan it, and the guy puts his fucking hand on my chest and goes, excuse me, does 14 come between 15 and 20? And I took my AirPods out. I said, what? What? And he goes, does 14 come between 15 and 20? He's doing this with his hands. Yeah. I'm like, what the fuck's happening?
It comes before 15.
I was like, no. I almost didn't know the answer. I was like, no. And he goes, well, then step aside and wait for your group. I said, there's no fucking way this is happening right now. So I stepped over and I'm like looking at everyone being like, can you fucking believe this guy? Like, I'm like, can you, I have to fight this guy.
They weren't doing it backwards, were they?
They were going back to front. Right? So I was like, what the fuck's happening right now? So I'm looking at people. I'm nervously laughing. I'm like, I'm going to fucking kill this guy. Right? So I'm standing there and he goes, rows 10 through 14 can now board. So I go up there and he and I scan it, look at him and he goes, oh, look who learned how to count.
Oh!
And I said, all right, now we have to fight. I have to punch you in the face or else I can't get on the plane.
Oh,
everyone's laughing.
Look who learned how to count.
And I got on the plane like a fucking cuck I am.
Well,
but
what are you going
to
do?
I should have punched him in the throat. Yeah. I've been thinking about it. I would have rather gone to jail than do what I did.
Yeah, that's
those are things
that's a movie scene. Like, that's literally like that.
Yeah, that's like a scene in Old School when Mitch is going through the fucking airport and everyone's like disrespecting him.
It was fucking
the cab
crazy.
Driver and everything. Yeah. I mean, but like, unless... See, in that moment, you have to be, like, a real baller. If in that moment, if you could be like, you know what, man? Like, you may win today, but your job is to take tickets to this airport.
Right.
And that, like, you know what? You know what, man? Everyone in the world fucking hates going to the airport, and that's every day of your life. You win this round, but you lose the war. But I'd rather just be able to fucking uppercut somebody.
Oh, dude.
See, I'd rather wouldn't. I would. Like, yes, in that moment, I'd be furious, obviously.
I was furious.
I'd rather do the throat thing.
I wish I would have just been like, fuck you, dude.
Yeah.
You know?
You should be able to say that.
I was one row off. Yeah. Fuck you,
and
man.
Also,
and we never board back to front.
Also, yeah. It's like, oh, I'm sorry. I thought I missed my one earlier, dick.
But the second I got, like, like one breath of, like, all right, I'd be like, oh, I can't wait to tell the story. I would be so excited.
I immediately texted the whole group. Yeah. Like, you wouldn't believe this asshole.
I get
the gate.
My anger. Like, right now, like, telling that story is so much more fun than fighting someone.
Well, it's like this again, is a great story. I don't want to fight people, but I want to, like, just like, if I wanted to, I want to be able to fucking kill people.
I just got, you got to like, be, I almost just, like in your situation, we got to just be so much more confident to be the asshole also. Yeah, and I'm never the asshole.
Never.
It's happened again on a fucking plane. When I upgraded. We were coming from California to New York. I splurged. I spent my own money to upgrade to like Comfort Plus, right? It was like $180 or something like that to get a fucking reclining seat and the whole thing. And I'm sitting there, and this fucking dog is next to me with this woman in the middle seat, right? And the dog's underneath my feet. I tweeted out pictures. I sent it. So this is all on the public record. Actually, maybe not. Maybe I sent it to – I could get you pictures, whatever. I'm the worst at telling stories. Fucking dog is under me. Golden Retriever is like laying underneath me. Huge fucking dog. To the point where I have my feet on my seat like this because I don't want to step on the dog, right? And the lady goes to me next to me.
You were on a plane like this?
We haven't taken off yet, right? And the lady, I'm trying to make noises like, this is insane, right? Like, this is insane, right? And it turns out she goes to me and she goes, you know, she goes, I'm so sorry about my dog. You wouldn't mind switching with my husband, right? He's just a couple rows back.
Out of comfort?
So I don't know, right?
Yeah,
so immediately I'm like, well, I have no other choice.
Yeah.
So it's either I sit like Indian style, like with my legs crossed or something like that, or I fucking move. So I get up. I'm like, sure, right? Mm-hmm. Like, fine. Turns out the guy who I switched with had this. He was sitting next to my original seat that I upgraded from. So I paid $180 to move up, then to be fucking told to go switch with the husband. And he's like bumping into me as he comes to my seat. And I'm sitting there in a middle seat now. Middle seat. All the way back to New York, and I'm like, why the fuck don't I have the balls to tell that fucking bitch to go sit next to her husband with the dog?
You switch with the guy next to you.
Yeah, go give go give someone back there the nice upgrade. Yeah. Why am I going back?
Right, right.
And that's a scam that couple runs. That's like mom and pop from Seinfeld. Yeah. She's been running that scam for 40 years.
Yeah, we'll only buy one.
We'll bring the dog with us. Yep. She'll shit on the chair. God. That kid'll get the fuck out of here.
I was repeating it in my head. I'm like, she actually said you wouldn't mind, right?
Right. So like, so there's no way to.
What, imagine saying
you
no, being
you
like, no,
be
I actually
so,
mind.
You wouldn't be so ridiculous to decline this offer.
Yeah.
So then you have to be like, no, I'm going to be an asshole.
Would anyone sitting here do that? Would you just be like, I kind of like the seat? I would say, I am so sorry.
Yeah, please. Sorry for me being
I am embarrassed for you that it took you this long to kick me out of my seat.
I would like to tell you that I would have the balls to say something like, you know,
I could see because you still got that New York in you. You're like, fuck off.
I have a little bit of that. I also would be like, you know, I need this seat just as much as your fuck. You know what I mean? Like you and your fucking dog. Like, I don't know. I could see myself maybe saying it, but more often than not. Also, what the fuck are you? It probably is a scam because why the fuck aren't you buying seats together with your
insane.
Fucking husband? You know,
dude.
If it was a kid, if a parent said to me like. I don't know why you'd be split up with your kids, but if it was like a 12-year-old or something and they're like, I would probably do that. But like two other grown adults, it's like, I don't think so.
I think if you have the confidence to ask anyone for anything in those situations, you're going to get what you want.
Yeah, definitely.
99% of the time.
That's life.
Right.
Like the people who walk in and ask for a raise, you're going to get it usually.
It's crazy.
The people who say, I'm taking a vacation, they don't ask for it. They're just doing it. The people who do things, get things.
Dude, there's a scene in The Office when... When Stanford comes back to Scranton, right? Jim comes back to Scranton. Yeah. And Ryan, the temp, has been sitting in his seat right in front of Pam.
Yes, yes, yes.
And he goes, yeah, Jim is a nice guy.
Yeah.
That's why I got the seat.
Right.
From the first time I saw that scene until every time I see that scene now, I still go, I'd rather be Jim.
Well,
I would rather be Jim. I'd be like, all right, fine. Like, you're a fucking asshole, man.
Right.
Fine.
Right.
I don't like.
You're an asshole work sometimes.
It's even perfect because, like, they stand there awkward and it's like,
yeah.
I'd be like, all right, I'm fucking out of here.
But that's
like,
an instance where Ryan is an asshole. But if you are an asshole to a bigger asshole, like your company or your boss or the man or whatever, and it's like, there's no love lost here. So, I don't give a shit. But otherwise, you're right. I would rather be known as like the nice.
Nice guys finish last. No, they fucking don't, man.
Right. Like, well, they do, but I also
don't think
we care.
I don't think nice guys finish last.
I absolutely think they do.
I'm a pretty nice guy. I'm all right.
You're finishing like middle
not
of the
better
pack.
Than last. Yeah. Better than last. It's not last. I'm not in first place. I'll give you that. But I'm not last.
Not in last place like, either.
I'm fine where I am.
Yeah.
I'm out $13 and a couple people on Twitter think I'm a liar. But I fucking hate you guys and I am triggered about it. I want to be clear about that. I fully admit, very triggered. But I'm like, I'd rather be like, here, enjoy your fucking beer, man. I'm not going to have these two women who English isn't their first language trying to figure out how to take their seat back and fucking cancel that order and blah, blah, blah. It's a pain in my ass. Just fucking here. Have your beer.
How about, I'll ask Frankie this question. We've done it a couple times recently. Like a homeless guy punched me in the back a couple months ago.
What?
Yeah. Like, not like maybe a homeless guy, definitely like a crazy guy. Like, just like.
Yeah, you think this guy had a home?
He wasn't like, I'm just saying he wasn't like soot on the skin homeless, you know? Yeah. So he might have like some sort of shelter. I'm crossing the street. I'm on the corner. He comes out of like a CVS right by the garden. And we like kind of come close to each other, but there was no contact. But it was just like regular New York City walking where, you know, you kind of move your shoulders, you dip around, whatever. And as I walk by, he just kind of does like knuckle. Ow, like ooh, knuckles to my vertebrae, you know, like
what the fuck?
And I was just like, ah, you know, kind of like the guy throwing his back out. Like,
how I want to get moan. How I want to moan.
Yeah. Yes. And I'm like, what do I do? And I did nothing.
You can't do anything. What are you going to get into a fist fight?
That's what I'm saying.
That's insane. There's
like, and first of all, I'm fighting either a homeless or a semi-homeless person, a definite crazy person, someone who I am worth more than. Like, it's a losing prospect, right? But like, at what point would you, if he punched you in the face, would you do something?
He Rick Moranis's you. Remember when that dude got fucking absolutely clocked? But even then. I think you have to fight back because then you're fighting for your life.
Nope.
No?
Nope. I mean, if he's
trying to kill you, yes. But if he just one punches you and keeps walking, it's like, all right, now I'm probably going to get punched in the face more.
True.
And what if I win this fight? Then there's like police and you know what I mean? So it's almost like the same way, like the people who ask you, they put you in a tough position and you're like, you're fucked from the jump. You know? Somebody threw something in my car the other day. I haven't told this story yet. So I was driving. It's kind of hard to explain, but there's a spot like getting off the hutch near my apartment where like you merge and then you merge again. So the whole, it's always just a mess, right? And me and another car, we were kind of being the assholes. We were merging late, but we both did it, you know? So like he merged late and then I merged late in front of him. But you know, usually if you're kind of cutting people off and someone cuts you off, I feel like you gotta like understand like we're both kind of being the dicks.
Yeah.
Either way, it didn't like really fuck with the flow of traffic. We both kind of cut in front of a truck that was going slow.
Yeah, that's the trick with that, by the way. I don't go all the way to the front, but I just wait until someone's a little slow and boom.
Yeah, that's
I,
all
I
the time.
I at least cut it in half, three quarters. That's fine, but I don't do like the last at the exit.
Yeah, where version. You're like in the painted zone.
Yeah.
I mean, I have done that, but I wasn't doing that this time. And it was like that. Then we get off the exit, and at the exit, you can go right or left. So I'm going right. And this person pulls up like alongside the other lane. And I don't know what they threw, but it was like loud and hard. Holy. And like hit my window. And I mean, shout out to Hyundai. That shit was more resistant than the fucking Elon right Musk truck. Yeah. Like, so it must have been something that wasn't like that hard, but it felt like I don't even know, like a fucking, like a mug. Like he threw like a cup at me or something. Yeah. Like it went. And it hit, like, it was a, if my window was open, it would hit me right in the face.
Holy shit.
It just went, like, bow, and, bounced off, and I heard the girl sitting shotgun said, we're gonna fucking kill you.
Oh, and, shit.
And then, but then they turned, and I turned, and
wait,
I.
The girl said to you, they're gonna fucking kill you?
Yeah. Yeah. Like, I think it was a guy driving, and she was shotgun. And I don't know if she threw it, because, again, I wasn't really expecting it, and I'm turning right. And all of a sudden I hear like bang and I kind of like jump and I don't realize even what happened. The window didn't break or anything. And I just hear him say, we're going to fucking kill you. But they turned and I turned and I was just like, oh, okay. Bro, you know? And I mean, had it broke, I probably am like spinning a U-turn and going after them. That's the one time I think I will like become an idiot is road rage because I don't know what happened.
I don't know what the psychology
of road rage is, but people become something they're not, you know?
I'm glad you bring this up, because before you even said that, I was going to turn into Bradley Cooper in Failure to Launch when he tells Matthew McConaughey, look, man, you're regularly getting bit by animals that don't bite. Like, do you think maybe something's out of whack with the way you're living your life? This is the second time in the last month someone's thrown something at your car?
When was the first time?
When someone, like, a homeless guy threw a water bottle at your car and a NYPD cop was standing right there and, like, no one did anything?
Yes, but that was a homeless person being a homeless person.
The homeless people
I've been in a lot of cars and Ubers around homeless people. They haven't thrown anything in any of them.
I had the green light, man. I was just driving through the intersection, and he just threw it.
This is two separate occasions in a month where someone's thrown something at you in a motor vehicle.
Listen, an oyster looks like a pussy, and people are throwing shit in my car. When you're right, you're right.
I'm always afraid for homeless people jumping in front of my car.
There's an interesting thought.
Like, they almost want that to happen,
right?
Like, I'm just waiting.
I'm sorry for victim blaming, by the way. You are clearly the victim in both of these situations, and I believe that.
I could see a homeless person, though, being like, I'll you know, maybe get some money out of this. Or
they get to go to the hospital.
What I'm surprised they don't do is jump in front of buses.
Big time.
Because then you get the city. You know, like if you sue me, I'm going to try to fight it. You get hit by a bus. They're going to be like, we'll settle for like 10 grand or some shit. Like, here you go, you know?
Oh, is that... Dude, I was just...
That's why
I've
always wanted to get hit by a cab or something like that.
I think that's a dream.
I don't know, by the way, but I would imagine. I would imagine that the city has an amount of money built in for like lawsuits.
Oh, yeah, we pay.
It's
all our money.
Yeah, it's all tax money. Yeah. So they're just like, give that person 25 grand so they go away.
Right. Dude, this article I was just reading, it's called about the Harlem Park Three, who were three guys in Baltimore who went to jail for like... The three of them combined... are the longest incarceration for innocent people in the history of America.
Mm-hmm.
They were each in jail for 36 years. How much do you think they each got?
Not a lot, right?
It's got to be over a million each.
No, I would
right?
say like a million each.
It was 3 million each, but I was like,
yeah, that's
you take like 36 years of my life.
All your good years, too. Okay, great. Now I get to live from like 60 to 90. Fuck you.
Dude, my like...
That's insane.
They were in fucking... they're in their 50s now. They were in... middle school. They were like 14.
Oh.
No, nah, maybe they were tried as adults. So maybe
probably like 16.
Yeah.
Between 14 and 16. I would never, I would, you got to give me like $25 million. You got to give me a million a year.
Bro,
you got to give me $36 million.
Maybe more. Maybe more.
Yeah.
I want $100 million.
And I'm like,
the article's
making
like they're all doing
stink.
Great financially. I guess, but also, do you have to pay tax? You can't pay taxes.
No, that'd be fucked up.
Right?
If the government takes your money back after you were sent to a government.
I'll take cash back.
Yeah. I mean, that's the kind of shit, man. I don't know what I've thought about that a lot. If I was in the Shawshank situation, because it's so funny, because, you know, you'd be like, dude, I know you heard this all the time. But I seriously
did not do this.
I just need you to listen to me. Like, look me in the eye, man. Right. And they've seen that 1,000 times. But it's like, but I swear to God,
One of the reasons that these guys' case got heard by, like, the innocent, it wasn't the Innocence Project, but it was one of those type deals, was because they'd maintain their innocence the whole time, and they're like, that's just, that
it
doesn't
never
happen.
Eventually you just cave, right?
well, like, these things... Like, how long does it take? Like, it's been 36 years. Like, this guy's been saying he's been 36. I guess we should look into it.
I've always thought that's crazy when they say, though, like, you will give a false confession after a while. And
right.
I'm like, no, I won't. But it's just like, yes, you do. Like, psychologically, they just, if they're torturing you and shit, like, they will just break you down to the point where, or I actually can understand where it's like, you fucked with me so much that I'm, like, broken. What I don't understand is the people who are like, wait, maybe I did do it. Like, they fucked with my head so much, maybe. It's like, you know if you murdered someone or not.
Well,
Hank, I can 99%.
See, yeah, Hank got...
What's her name? In Italy,
Man and Knox. Did she like start?
She said that like they kind of the way they asked her questions in a different language. They started to make her think that she did do it. Like,
that's,
where were you? You don't know where you were last night. Like,
I mean, I guess if it's like you were blackout drunk or something. But to me, it's like I would feel like I would stick to my guns and be like, nah, I didn't murder that
person. What if you were Trent and you woke up in the drunk tank in a fucking
that's what I mean. That's different.
And they're like, if you killed someone last night. You'd be like. Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Like,
that would be a great prank.
I don't
prank,
think I did.
Be a great prank. That's like your buddy whose dad told him he chopped his balls off,
blew his dick off.
Yeah.
In this case, what they did was they convinced other kids, not even convinced, they just like threatened other kids with jail time, being like, this is who you saw.
That's what I mean. That kind of shit, like, I understand.
But there were times throughout their 36 years where they were up for parole. But in order for parole, you have to show contrition for what you did.
And you have to admit
and
it.
And they were like, no, we didn't do it. And they're like, just say you're sorry, we'll let you out. And like, I'm not saying sorry.
That's cocky.
I would be like, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
See you later.
Yeah, right. Like, if I could get out, sure. That's nuts. Good for those fucking guys. Let's do some Emma the Assholes. And no, we got to do some erotic reading. Right?
Ah, yes.
What does that mean?
We're going to do some, what do they call that? Like a read out loud thing. An erotic reading is what we're going to do.
Yeah.
And so in order to get ready for it, I want everyone to pop some Roman. I want you to get your swipes so you can last a little bit longer. If you're at home right now, rub your Roman swipes on your dick and get ready to masturbate a little bit longer, because that's what Roman does for you. The Roman swipes help you last like that much longer in bed. So you get how long do you think you last in bed? Give me an average minutes,
bro. Oh, all right, let's
average
do this.
Average minutes.
Yeah. Like when that girl was making fun of DK Metcalf because he's like he busted in 5 minutes. Well, yo, 5 minutes is just a session of sex.
Bro, I could do it in...
That's 300 seconds, man.
I'm telling you right now, I could do it in 12 seconds.
I could go fast.
Yeah.
But I actually sent a tweet on Saturday.
8 seconds.
Where it was like...
I'll go single digits on your
Could you... Could you how many pumps do you think you get it done?
Two.
Two?
Could you,
if you wanted to let it loose, yeah.
Just... Like, ah! Just over. Just like...
Dude,
then I'm fucking sitting there like, ah, fucking, my urge to moan and fucking come. Get me off the show.
On Saturday, I sent a tweet with like, was it a Mountaineer? It was, I don't know, one of the college football like mascots doing push-ups, and like he just was doing really bad push-ups.
Yeah. Same.
And I was like, oh yeah, man, you really gave her the business. Me after doing this for exactly 246 or whatever number I made up in my head. And like a lot of people were like, whoa, sick brag. Again, we make fun of ourselves a lot on this. It's not like crazy for 2 minutes. That's craziness could even make a joke like, oh, sick brag. That's not enough time to have sex.
Well, I'm gonna
be audacious and say
it's a matter of like, I feel like I can come really fast, yeah. And I can also not come. You know, like I saw the girls from Horrible Decisions did a bit. I think they said the average male thrusts between I think 40 and 60 times. I think that's what sex was.
Really?
Which is like
that seems low.
Yeah, because I'm thinking like one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. If I do that 4 times, 6 times, that's over. But like you got to think, average people. Frankie's like, yeah, man.
I did like.
What do you think the fastest you ever come is? Like the other day, I came in like 10 seconds.
Yeah, I was just say probably.
I don't know what happened. I just had a bad performance.
8 to 10.
It was in the morning after, and I and that's weird too, because usually I mean, you know, I fucked the night before. Then in the morning, I was just like, oh well, you know. I also just do not give a fuck though.
Right.
That's a young man's game, right. Being upset about coming. I was just like, well, that was funny, huh?
That's a young man's game.
I also feel like. Maybe not when you're young. I don't know about Jackie, but like, I think there's some level of, I think chicks like are flattered by that sometimes. I think there's a situation where it's like, damn, like that guy thinks I'm that hot. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. But, I also think that we were talking with Whitney Cummings about it. Like, she was saying like, if you don't come fast enough, we think that you're cheating, or we think that you're not like into us, or all that.
That's
so
insane.
You know, you get your nut off quick enough, and they're like, ooh, ooh.
All these problems start coming as you just can't.
Just because you come. Yeah. You know,
sorry for giving you the business.
Yeah,
sorry for getting Roman on your ass.
Sorry I was using a Roman swipe and you didn't know, man. You rub that Roman swipe on, you're gonna last that much longer. You can do those extra positions, you can get those extra minutes in. And they've got the pills to get your dick hard, the swipes to keep it lasting. They've got pills and vitamins to grow your hair, to have healthy skin, all of that. So go to GetRoman.com/KFC. You can get the first month of swipes for just $5 when you choose a monthly plan. That's GetRoman.com/KFC. So there was this dude on Twitter who basically was blaming, like, politics, right?
Well, this is actually going to be easy for someone like you to understand if you spend a lot of time on Reddit. Do you do, like, the front page of Reddit, too, or just, like, porn?
I sometimes think I need
Wait,
to start
that,
going.
That, he goes,
like, I think I know what the answer is.
It's usually just the porn. But yeah, I'll fuck around on the regular side. It's super boring. It's
like, I just scroll.
It's
like,
cute dog. Why is it not getting fucked?
I'll just scroll the front page. And there's a lot. r/ men writing women is a popular subreddit, where it's just like guys who tried to write about women, where it's almost like her vagina was like a beautiful oyster. Okay. And it's like, that doesn't make any sense, man.
Right.
So there's this. This is kind of stems from that, I think, where there's an award for most poorly written sex scene in a novel.
Okay.
And so this guy gets really mad about it. He has a op-ed called Men Are Write-Offs When It Comes to Novels. He said, even in my own 2005 novel, Winkler, was no sooner in print than winning the Bad Sex Award. 3 years of effort, some perfectly decent words in roughly the right order, and all I got was a load of raspberries blown at me by a room full of plummy virgins who'd come from suave and strip, who'd only come from suave and strippers. Scorn and mockery, boys. Scorn and mockery. That's all there is in the novelist's life. So now there's also the excerpt of what was
so
nominated.
I'm expecting to think that this is going to just be like a perfectly normal sex scene, but maybe like, you know, a couple things that like just describing the girl's body parts incorrectly. You know what I mean?
Okay.
We're going to have a contest. All three of us are going to read this.
Okay.
See who doesn't look sexy.
Okay.
Actually, I know it, so I'm going to go last. We're going to have Frankie go first.
Okay.
So I have to read this and try and sound sexy?
Yeah.
Holy fuck. I'm never sexy. Oh, shit.
Read it to yourself in your head first, because it's so bad that...
No, you read out loud.
Read out
loud.
Let it rip. Okay. I mean, there's not even, like, punctuation. This is tough.
Come on.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit. I don't even know if I could start this. I'll start crying laughing. I don't know how to sound sexy. And he came hard in her mouth. And his dick jumped around and rattled on her teeth. What? And her dick rattled on her teeth and he blacked out. He blacked out. She took his dick. Took her dick out of her mouth and lifted herself from his face and whipped the pillow away, and he gasped and gagged for air. How glugged at the air. And he came again so hard that his dick wrenched out of her hand and shot out of him straight in the eye and stung like nothing he'd ever been.
No, I can't read this. I'm crying, dude.
And he yelled with the pain, but the yell couldn't have been anything. And she grabbed at his dick, which was leaping around like a shower dropped in an empty bath. She scratched his back deeply with the nails of both hands, and he shot three more times in thick stripes on her chest like Zorro. Dude, I'm crying. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh my god.
Dude, that was worse than I remember. My
sorry.
God, Winkler. What does that even mean, Winkler?
That's one of the funniest things I've ever read. And then he blacked out.
What about the teeth? I don't think
that one got far. The teeth, dude.
The
so
teeth,
why
was it rattling in her teeth?
This dude's dick is like a fucking snake in a Pringles can. Where it's jumping all over the place.
Dude, when
I have come so many times in my life, my dick has never jumped anywhere. Well, it does the one little.
Also, how many times?
It does like a hut. My dick huts. And that's it. Then it's done. There's no more jumping.
When I was like skimming through it to see what I was about to read, I saw teeth and black out, and that's where it just I couldn't get past it.
Like this how does this guy come so many times so fast? And he came hard in her mouth, and his dick jumped around and rattled on her teeth as he blacked out. She took his dick out of her mouth, lifted herself from his face, whipped the pillow around, and he gasped and he glugged at the air, Frankie. He glugged at the air. He came again so hard his dick wrenched out of her hand. A shot of it hit him straight in the eye and stung like nothing had ever stung in the air. He yelled with pain. He moaned like Frankie moans. But the yell could have been anything. As she grabbed at his dick, which was leaping around like a shower dropped in an empty bath. She scratched at his back deeply with the nails of both hands, and he shot three more times in the thick stripes of her chest like Zorro. What is that even? I don't know what any of these references are.
These are all straight up sandbags.
Yeah.
These are. This is, bro, like, bro, you. This is named Giles Corin.
That guy is
bro,
never fucked.
Bro, you should fuck somebody before writing about fucking.
You should not be a virgin, dude. Goodness gracious.
Whoo.
And
he came harder than her
mother. Oh, we're going Antonio Banderas.
And his dick jumped around and rattled on her teeth, and he blacked out. And she took his dick out of her mouth and lifted herself from his face and whipped the pillow away. And he gasped and clucked at the end. And he came again so hard that his dick wrenched out of her hand and shot it. Oh, it hit him straight in the eye. And he stung. Oh, it stung like nothing he'd ever been in there. And he yelled with the pain, but the yell could not have been anything. As she grabbed at his dick, which was leaping around. Which was leaving around like a shower dropped in an empty bath.
What? Wait, let's start. What does that mean? What does that line mean? It leapt around like a shower dropping in an empty bath.
Is this converted from another language?
No, he's it's, British.
It feels
I think.
That way. British,
bro, this motherfucker is British. That's a
that dude.
That dude looks like a guy in a Harry Potter.
This guy sucks.
Like he fucks like a British person. Like think about all the porn you've ever watched. You're not really hearing English accents ever. You know what I mean? British people can't fuck.
Except that dude Danny D with the biggest fucking cock
he's got
in the world.
Fucking hammer.
Oh my god. But anyway, that
was pretty damn good.
That was good. I'm happy to be the worst of the bunch on that one. But
I heard a Zorro reference. I was like,
I didn't
go
even read any of it.
Feitelberg clutched his chest and then wiped his face.
Yeah.
Oh, amazing. The pain. Oh, you guys didn't come?
Am I the Assholes? We got them?
Yeah.
And then we'll do some voicemails. We'll let you get out of here, Frankie. Am I the Asshole today is brought to you by Shady Rays. You want to get some sunglasses? Get some Shady Rays, because not only are you going to get the sunglasses, you're also going to help a good cause. Let me tell you the three reasons why you should get your Shady Rays sunglasses. They're high-quality shades for far less than the expensive brands. One. Number two. They have one of the best warranties in the game. They will replace any lost or broken sunglasses with a lifetime craftsmanship warranty. And number three.
What's the third?
You get 10 meals will be donated to fight hunger in America.
Oh, that should be numero uno.
That's pretty tough.
Because I'm a nice guy. So
oh, yeah, you're a hero.
I like number
you're a
three
natural hero.
To be important. Oh, yeah. Yes, the craftsmanship, the guarantee, that's all fantastic.
But the homeless people.
That's what I care about.
You could either buy sunglasses and let people starve to death, or you could buy sunglasses and save starving people.
Hey, it's up to you. It's your business.
No-brainer.
It's up to you, pal. I know what I'm picking. Shady Rays, they start at just $48. I've bought Shady Rays before. When you put the promo code in, it's KFC. It's 50% off, so you're doing a little BOGO, a little buy one, get one. When you put in two pairs and it says, you know, 48 plus 48, and then there's like a tax and this and that, and it says like $112, and then you put in the promo code and it just drops down to like $50, it's fucking amazing. It's like that watching that transformation happen, you're gonna get two pairs
just
for the
all
price
the
of
money
one.
You're saving for Scrooge McDuck. Rich now.
John,
this is beautiful.
It feels like a shower pouring in a bath. Let me tell you, I started glugging at the air when I saw this deal. My teeth were rattling. That's how I feel when I see the discount on Shady Rays. ShadyRays.com, promo code KFC, $50 for two pairs or more. ShadyRays.com, promo code KFC. All right. This is where we play the game where pretty much everyone's always an asshole.
It's quitting my job.
Okay. Am I the asshole? I made my wife go back to work by lying about quitting my job as well. My wife didn't like her job. I was telling her to look for a new job while she was still in her current company. She wanted to take a break from work, but we cannot afford it right now due to our accidental conception. She's 3 months pregnant. So
do you think it's rude to say that? Like, if I ever get someone pregnant, it's an accident. So I'm going to say, I'm not going to be like, yeah, we're so happy. I'm like, yeah, it was a mistake.
Wait, to who? Who are we talking to? Who are you talking to when you say this?
Like, I'm
just in public?
John Feitelberg on this show.
Talking about this show.
I'm not going to pretend like.
Yeah, no, like, I feel like Kate is very open about, like, it was not a plan.
Yeah.
I think that's the way you say it.
I can still love the kid, but be like, yeah, that wasn't intentional.
I don't think you can't say mistake. Accidents even tough.
We'll call
I think
it an oopsie.
I think if you oops a baby, or you say we didn't plan it.
Is that a phrase or did you just make that up?
Oops a baby?
Yeah.
That's a phrase. I would love to take credit.
Oops a baby?
Oopsie baby.
That's a good one.
Yeah, I like that.
That's a good one.
I made her resume and I applied her for a few interviews. However, she didn't attend any of them, saying she doesn't feel like it. She said she wants to be a stay-at-home mom. I told her we weren't even planning for this pregnancy, and now we cannot afford for her to become unemployed as well. She didn't listen and just quit her job without consulting me. I was super mad at her. I told her I don't want to bust my ass while she relaxes at home. She cried and said that she doesn't want to work anymore, so I told her I'd be quitting my job as well, and then we could both stay jobless and homeless with our child. I pretended to quit the job in front of her by sending an angry email to my boss, but instead sent it to my friend. She was shocked and asked me why I do such a thing. I told her tough luck and went to sleep. The next morning onwards, she got ready for an interview and started to attend interviews. I called my work and took a break of 1 week. Today, my wife got a job and she gave me the news at night while we were having dinner. I then told her the truth about my not quitting the job and about it being a way to make her go back to work. She got mad at me, told me I was very petty and I should have just sucked it up and let her stay at home. Now she's not talking to me. This is an interesting one.
This is okay. So like,
man,
I kind of blacked out for the first part of it.
This man is brilliant.
How long has she been out of work?
Not long. I think it was like.
And she is pregnant, or she has had the baby.
She's 3 months pregnant.
Okay.
She wants to quit and be a stay at home mom.
She's only 3 months pregnant. She's not 3 months post birth.
Three months pregnant. Correct.
All right, barely even showing. Not even telling the family.
Right. You're barely telling people. Yet.
Yeah.
You haven't even put up your Instagram post yet. So she is like, I'm going to quit and stay at home. He goes, okay, well, I quit too. Now we have no income. So she gets back out there and starts applying to places. So I would imagine he took 1 week off. So it's probably about a week or two of her not working.
I think this is I think postpartum, you're probably an asshole.
Yeah.
3 months pregnant, well, girl, go get work out in those fields.
bend over. Run that back. I think this guy is brilliant. I think he's just an idiot for telling her. This plan worked to perfection.
Yeah, but you gotta. I
oh
see
no, but then he's got to go back.
He's
got to
go
job.
Back to work, right?
So he
can get another job if you want to keep the lie going. But
well,
I also think
he's got to. I went back and I groveled and I got back to my job. Whatever. There's better ways out of this than to admit that you completely manipulated her.
I think if you're fucking,
you are the asshole. If I'm the girl, I'm like, well, we have to raise this kid together, but otherwise I would dump the fuck out of you.
All right, this relationship sucks.
That's a wild betrayal to lie about that.
I don't think
and
so.
It is.
That's encouragement.
Crazy. It's not.
It is. It's inspiration.
No.
It's,
no.
It's fine. Okay, fine. How about this? It's a look into a crystal ball.
Yeah, it's like, it's scaring. It's a scare tactic.
It's, sure. And sometimes those can be successful.
Yes, but it's not
but
encouragement.
If someone did it to me, I would be like, whoa.
Well played. Yeah, yeah.
All right, yeah.
You know what it is? It's like the way Dave manages people. It's like, it's effective. It will, you know, you'll get the job done,
yeah.
But it will fucking scar you and ruin you. That's kind of what happened here. It's like, listen, babe, you got the job. We're good. But in order to do it, I had to fuck with you mentally and emotionally.
Oh, I see. I can picture myself telling the story, being like, we're at dinner, we're drinking wine, now we're both employed, we're living lavishly. And champagne, in fact. Champagne, we're both having a nice steak dinner.
Oysters.
And I'm like, you know how we are both avoided this? You're going to love this. I fucking sent that email to Steve. And I didn't just fucking sat on the couch for a week, had Oreos. And then.
What a week off for that guy.
Yeah. And then, like I would picture her being like, you fucking got me, John.
And that's how you picture
it,
huh?
That is. You got it.
You picture your wife doing the old,
and then clink. Like, oh, look at us. Our 401ks are looking great because of you.
Knife to the neck, really, in reality.
That is one of the most manipulative things of all time.
Yeah.
But she's also the asshole for being like, I just want to be a stay-at-home mom when that's like not financially in the cards.
It's if he knows the numbers.
You're not a mom.
If they know the numbers and that they can't live life without two incomes, he absolutely did the right thing because you have to just like push your significant other, whoever that he considers her, because I mean, where they are they? They're not.
Dating,
it's not a wife, right?
Yeah.
So whatever.
Baby
so
mama.
You have to push her to do something.
No, it did say wife. Sorry.
Okay, so he has to push her because he probably knows we are not surviving without two jobs, and she refuses to do this. So I have to go to this crazy length.
I got a job I can quit over email with one email.
Right.
I'm not bringing in a ton of money.
I was going to say, this sounds like, you know, it sounds like he sent an email like to quit at, like Jimmy John's.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, not that big of a deal. What I think you can do. I think you could be like, okay, cool. The next day you show up with like applications for a new apartment that's like half the size, and be like, okay,
this is what we can afford.
And I'm bringing the car in today. I'm gonna trade it in for like a, you know, a little like 2-door piece of shit, and like all those presents I bought you like for Christmas, we gotta return all that,
dude.
You scare them in that.
I'm dealing with this right now.
Are you?
With we were looking at a house that has
congratulations.
Thank
by
you
the
very much.
Oh, is it out there?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It is. Yeah, I put it on Instagram.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Frankie's engaged. Thank Congratulations.
You very much. Appreciate it.
I would have led off with that. I didn't know if it was
thank
public
you.
Or not.
But anyway, we're looking for a house. I'm trying. I'm not mansplaining, but I'm trying to explain.
Oh, we know how Frankie mansplains.
when your team loses, you don't be like, "I want to become a Red Sox fan." We're just saying like they're in a better spot than us. Do you get that?
Oh. Do I get that?
Like,
oh, no. Are you mansplaining that we just lost the season?
That's not mansplaining.
That's not
mansplaining. That's not mansplaining.
No, dude. The idea that
Frankie talks, he mansplains.
This house that we really like and we put an offer in on has a fucking garage that was converted into a two-bedroom apartment. There's rent that's going to be paid, right? So, like, so whatever you offer on the house, it's not actually that number because you're going to be getting an income from the garage.
Yes.
So I'm putting out all these numbers and she's like, she wasn't grasping that that's not the price of the house, right? I'm like trying to explain like, no, when you think about it, that income coming from that garage is basically like its own loan coming towards you. You know what I mean?
Right.
So like, so let's say the house is like, let's say the house, right, comes to tenants that I want to say. So I'm like, let's say the house is $850,000, like the offer. It's actually $500,000 if you really think about it. And she's like, right. But where's $850,000 coming from? I'm like, I'm going to go downstairs. I'm going to get a gun. I'm going to shoot myself in the head already.
But she's not wrong if you got to pay that money to get the house.
Totally.
Right. So like,
but it's technically not that number because each month you minus it by the rent.
But as far as like a down payment and certain things like that, the $850.
Yes, it is. But I felt like this guy where it's like I have to almost like trick her, be like, you know, it's actually $500. It's actually $400. It's actually $400.
Yeah.
Even though at the end of the day, it's like it really is that, but it's not.
Dude, that's where
there's a lot of shit that I feel like.
One of the things I really like, hope it's not too late, but I remember being like, getting the ring and getting married was a thing that I needed to get used to. Homeowning together
nightmare
was a real, like, that was a big problem that led to a lot of the issues where it was like, we did not see eye to eye on a lot of things in that department. And when you own a house and shit goes inherently, actually you guys are probably good because you're both from Long Island, right?
Yeah.
Like if you both live in different places, someone's going to lose that battle.
I can't imagine losing a battle with something petty. That big.
Yes. That, no. Honestly.
Because right now we're battling about things we want.
I should have moved where she wanted and I would have just had to deal with that because every time something was wrong, it was like, well, I didn't want to fucking be here.
Dude.
And it was just like, it
so,
was cursed from the
it's
jump.
Such a big moment that you have to be on the same page about if you're not.
Well, mine made so much more sense because I was like, if we're near my family can help more with our kids than your family because your family works. But that, did not translate. And it was like, losing that battle is almost worth it. But but like when you have to fix things and things get broken and things go wrong and things like, it just, it's, and all, of course it is because it's like, your whole life, you're just like dicking around, right? Now, all of a sudden, you're going to buy something that's $850,000.
But it's actually not. It's actually $410,000 when you take it. Yeah. It's actually not that money. It's, it's not.
You keep beeping it.
So who's the asshole? Final answer.
She is.
She is.
I think they all are. Everyone's the asshole there.
I think he's a fucking... It's the guy. It's fucking Jack Nicholson in... what is it? Men of Honor, but it's like you need me, okay? If there wasn't that
you
guy,
need me
if
on that
guy
wall.
Wasn't running the finances of the household, you need and in if I'm ever like in a marriage, I'm not gonna be that guy. So she's gonna need to be that guy who fucking runs the finances. Like, look, we need both of these salaries. This is what you need to make. Someone's gotta keep the fucking finances of the house in line. One person spends wildly. One person keeps shit in order. I'm the spend wildly person.
I'm just looking for another asshole.
Me and you made the same noise there, Zach. Same time. Fucking weird. We both went. That was fucking nuts. It sounded like it echoed.
All right, how about this one? This one was submitted from a listener. Am I the asshole for asking a guy I dated for my money back? 2 years ago, I went on a couple dates with a guy. He worked for a company that gave him early access and discounted tickets for Taylor Swift's Lover Fest. Oh. He knew I was a huge fan and offered to get tickets for my friends and I. I paid him. He got the tickets. All good. After a few weeks, I realized it just wasn't a love connection. We had very little in common. He seemed to pride himself on not knowing normal movie references because he, quote, didn't watch them.
That person is an ass.
That guy's an ass. We're like, story's over. Story is over.
This guy sucks.
As soon as he said he was, quote, surprised they killed Batman's parents in The Joker, I saw the light and his flaws, including being upset that I was not texting him enough, despite the fact that I had gotten in a car accident and was suffering from a concussion. Oh my God. I know he was really hurt and rejected. He asked me to be his girlfriend, and I said no, but I knew we weren't right for each other, and he was looking for a girlfriend. Fast forward to the pandemic, ultimately canceling Lover's Fest. The money was all refunded. Since he's the one who originally bought the tickets, he was refunded, but has completely ignored me when I've asked for my money back. It's like $2,000, and I owe the other people. Am I the asshole for rejecting him and not talking to him for almost 2 years, but expecting to get my money back when the concert gets canceled? Too long, didn't read. A guy I dated bought me ticket concerts that I paid him for. COVID canceled the concert, and I want my money back.
All right, so he's obviously the asshole.
Right, right?
But
I mean, I
feel like it was a little sneaky dropping that movie line in there. Because there might be more of a debate to be had. There's not a debate to be had. It's her money and all that, but like...
Wait, there's a debate to be had about Batman?
No.
Or just not knowing the movie references?
Not knowing the movie references. Oh. That was immediately... Fuck this guy. He sucks. Like,
oh, so she tainted the waters on this one.
If this could have been about anything, she just dropped it in there. Like, I fucking hate this guy.
She knew what she was doing.
Spider-Man. Who is that? I haven't seen that movie. I've been a little busy. Like, fuck you, dude.
Could you imagine watching any Batman movie and someone being like, oh my God, his parents died?
Yeah,
like, that's how every Batman has always started.
What an interesting adaptation that one is. Yeah, you see the pearls fly.
I think, I mean, if you buy tickets and the movie, like, that guy just made $2,000. Mm. You can't.
Right. He's the asshole no matter what.
Right.
But that is poisoning the well. Yeah. Being like, he doesn't watch movies and then like says he doesn't understand references. Like, fuck the guy, you son of a bitch. That's how you operate in society.
What would you do though if like you're sending, like, you text this guy, he's not answering. You send him another message, you're not answering. You're like increasingly being like, hey man, I know that we like didn't work out, but like I kind of need my money back. Because eventually if you're like, fuck you, dude, where's my money? Then he's definitely not gonna answer.
Yeah, I mean, this guy's such an asshole, I would, like, go to the authorities.
I would go to, like, people's court. Like, small
right.
claims
yes,
court.
Yes, I want to defeat him. Yes, yeah. I want him to cry that he has to hand me the money back.
What, like, if it was my ticket, I think we all know what I would do.
Just be like, whatever, yeah.
I'm eating the ticket.
I would even be like, yo, I understand it's $2,000. Maybe he had spent some cash. Like, we can get on, like, a payment plan here or whatever, you know what
How
I mean?
How many,
like,
tickets did he buy?
I don't know. She said it was $2,000 total.
Yeah, that's a lot. I mean, Taylor, I was obviously going to go to Loverfest as well.
If you get like front row tickets, isn't that like a lot?
Oh, it's crazy expensive.
Yeah, yeah.
But like, any concert, if he's getting through work and he's getting a deal on him, like, I assume he's got an in and he's getting him at face value.
I bet you he did that too. I bet you he fucking got, he probably like got these tickets for free, took the money from her, got the
This guy sucks.
Yeah.
This guy sucks.
Voicemails today are brought to you by Sling TV. We've switched over to video voicemail because watching the podcast is the superior way to enjoy podcasts. I understand not everyone could do it. You want to do it at work. You want to do it on commute. You don't have to do it. I'm just saying, if you have the ability at night to pop on the podcast, it's a better way to do it. Just like when you're watching Sling TV, you get access to all your live sports, live news. You get access to the Barstool Sports Channel 24/7. The Dozen. Oh my God, my dozen matchup this week. One of the greatest competitions of all time.
Really?
We were down 10-5.
Holy shit.
With 5 questions left, and we won.
Holy
We ran
shit.
The table and stole, and we won 11-10. We were playing Uptown Balls. Smitty, Tommy.
Oh, that had to have killed Tommy.
Dying.
Oh.
And it was funny because... Balls keeps doing Friends as his niche.
I saw he went 0-2, right?
Oh, and they were, I didn't know the answer, but it was this cosmetic device tipped off Joey that Chandler and Monica were dating. Now, I don't know that, but if you're a Friends expert, the episode where two of the main characters get outed as dating,
right.
That's like a huge moment.
Huge.
Eyelash curler,
yeah. I mean, right? Like, if you know Friends, I didn't know it, but I'm like, you got it.
I haven't watched in a while, that's...
And you know it, yeah. So, he gets that wrong. Then baseball comes up. Tommy wanted to double baseball. They didn't do it. And at the end, they were all yelling, "We should have doubled baseball!"
Oh,
it was
my God.
So,
I can't wait
the
to
best
fucking
part
shit
was,
on him for this.
The best, I loved it personally because I had my best Dozen game ever, and then we had a big comeback. So I haven't, you know, I got to thank Jeff D. Lowe and the Dozen because there's no, you know, we do stool streams and shit, but trivia I'm like better at, you know, like using my brain. It felt great to like compete and win something, right? So the final category, though, was snacks. And I'm like, all right, I'm in pretty good shape here, you know? So the first question was, Kellogg's has this popular soft-baked breakfast bar. Either of you?
Soft-baked.
So I'm thinking, I'm thinking like Kind bars and granola bars. Nutrient. So I get that with like 5 seconds to go. Ooh. I'm like, same thing you did though. Like, oh, Nutrient.
Yeah.
So 5 seconds to go, we get it. The next question goes to them. What is the name of Nabisco's graham crackers brand? Whatever.
I think I have dementia.
Honey grams.
It's not, but you're close. Oh. What?
I have dementia. Yeah. I do. Full blown. I can't remember anything. I know nothing.
I'm with you when I... This
no, was, dude, the, you're not only, with me at
no,
all.
No, I am, though. Because,
I know nothing.
Because I felt this way, like, this was the only time I've ever really been good at an episode of The Dozen. When they, especially when they do these sports questions that are like this Big Ten quarterback from like 1997
nothing.
Who was a backup, like, and they're just like, bam. I mean, I got no shot.
Nope.
And I feel like these questions are either like, they're almost like memory. It's not like you can really like think your way through it. You either know it or you don't. And I'm always like, you know, Rudy will be like, KFC, like, you got anything here? I'm like, oh no, I'm checked out.
Yeah.
Like, I literally can't compete. Like, I can't contribute because no. I just, you either know it or you don't, you know? But it was,
that's a good feeling.
I got fat a while ago and I was making homemade s'mores. I was just at home just making my own s'mores and they're called Honey Made.
Honey
and,
Made.
And I knew it and they're answering first and they're saying Teddy Grahams and animal crackers, all this dumb shit. And I'm sitting here being like, I'm about to walk off a huge upset comeback win, not upset, but a comeback win with Honey Made.
Oh.
Like, oh my God. It was amazing. It was incredible. Anyway, this Sling TV has the Barstool Sports Channel 24/7. It has all the live sports. You can watch all this sort of shit that I'm talking about here. And your first month is only $10 when you go to sling.com/barstool. After that, just $35 a month. It's sling.com/barstool for your first month for just $10. Video voicemails. Let's see some of these idiots and their beautiful faces. What do we got?
All right, what's going on, KFC? Fights, everybody behind the camera. So I was listening to last week's episode where bi-curious suicidal Skyler was talking about how when a guy or a gay guy compliments you, it means way more than if a straight girl does. And it reminded me of a time when I was at a bar and this guy came up to me and he started hitting on me and he bought me a drink. And we just started chatting a little bit. And at the end of it, he had bought me like 3-4 drinks.
Oh, come on.
And I finally decided to tell him that I was straight. And I felt really guilty about kind of leading him on just to get free drinks. And then I realized, wait, girls do this all the time. They probably have never felt guilty ever. So why should I feel guilty? So should I have felt guilty? And Jackie, do girls ever feel guilty? Because I just guarantee they never do.
Here's the difference. Because he's not wrong. But there is like a glimmer of hope in the guy's mind when you are just assuming a normal heterosexual situation. If a guy is coming up to a guy buying drinks, when anybody buys a drink, it's obviously like in order to try to like hook up.
Yeah, if you say, hey, let me get you a drink. If we're just talking, I'm like, oh, you need something?
That's different.
That's different.
If you buy a guy three or four rounds.
I'll do that. I'd do that.
Because you're gay.
I wouldn't do it to a stranger, but like, because I just drink fast. And I always end up buying, if I go out with like four people, I will buy drinks. I'll drive 90% of the drinks.
Because you're ready for another one.
Oh, yeah.
You
right. Also different when you're in a crowd, though. Like, this guy got approached.
This guy sits down.
Yeah.
Three or four drinks. And like you're saying, he knew the whole time it's impossible.
There's literally no chance.
Correct.
Like a girl, as much as she's definitely using you to just get the drinks, and she knows it. It's like 99.9%, but she can trick herself and be like, I don't know, maybe a couple drinks in, I'll want to, or maybe he'll get better, or maybe he'll be more funny, or whatever. This is like, there's no attraction here. But also, that guy, I feel like gay guys have got to have better gaydar in the sense of like, I feel like I would be rude. Yeah, of course, you're the gay guy.
It's like, you're the fuck,
why else are you here? I think it's rude to put me in a position.
Rattled, but like, assuming this wasn't at a gay bar,
right?
Which
gay bar? Then this dude's completely in the wrong.
Totally.
Then
you go to a gay bar, you're the asshole. Yeah.
But like, I would never assume Yeah, I mean, yeah, no. I would never assume.
You're looking at that guy being like, yeah, he's, I'll fuck.
That was mean.
Well, no, well, that guy looks straight as fuck.
I mean, like, but exactly. Like, I don't know.
That's a pretty shitty.
I mean, so do you guys.
Goatee's gay.
He's got some thick ass lips, dude.
Yeah. He does have some thick ass lips.
Bro,
what the hell?
That guy buys me a couple drinks. I might fuck.
I was going to say, bro. I was going to say, like, I'm.
You buy me five drinks, I'm going to maybe.
Maybe what?
I don't know. I think being Frank going to say, Patreon. Like, I wouldn't understand what was happening until I was sucking that. I'd be like,
how'd this happen?
I got a mouthful of cock. Be like, well, he bought me that.
Mike walks out with three fucking Z's, like what just happened to me?
this guy's very forthcoming.
Yeah, but also he says like, I didn't tell him until three or four drinks. Like it seemed like he knew that was like,
well,
he
that's
was gay,
right? But that what's fucked up is to make me say to you, hey, listen, man, I'm not straight. That sounds like, I'm not gay. That sounds very presumptuous.
Yeah, yeah, right? Yeah.
Like then if it was me, I'd be like, oh, like what? Somebody, like everyone wants to fuck you, dude? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because
like, we're just having a nice conversation, man. That's like, I would be so afraid of either being offensive and him being like, yeah, I'm not gay either.
Right, right. Or like, I would never fuck you, you fucking
like,
ugly
or
shit.
Or like having someone think I was being mean. I go out of my way to not be mean, because I don't want to accidentally be an inspiration story. Like, I don't want one day, like, someone be telling a story, be like, there was one time this guy was kind of rude to me in a bar, and I decided that day that I would stand for something different. Like, I don't ever want to be that guy. You know, like that viral tweet, the girl be like, in fifth grade, a boy told me girls can't be astronauts. And that's why I decided I'd be that. So, like, I'm never telling anyone fucking anything, because I'm not inspiring you to do shit. I'm not going to be the villain in a biopic, okay? So I just be like, yeah, I would be gay. And then anyway, I just fucked this guy. I would not be presumptive. I'm not like, he's...
That was amazing.
That was great. Also, it's pretty hard to be like, if someone's like, hey, can I buy you a drink? And you just respond, no, I'm straight.
Yeah. Like, this...
What?
This is either... What? Like, he must have been in... Maybe not a gay bar, but maybe like gay part of town, like gay neighborhood, or like, looking around. Yeah,
you know what I'm queers saying. Up there.
He was in the South End of Boston, 1983. Right.
Come on, like, was there a rainbow flag on the fucking wall or some shit? Like, this sounds, this does not really happen. Like, you know what I mean, right? Yeah, how many times?
For sure not, never. I would never go up to someone in like a straight bar and be like, yeah, like, be like, oh, I wonder if he's gay. Unless they were like, I don't know.
How
they
many
had painted nails and wore an earring?
Yeah,
and I'd be like, guy's probably a queer.
How many times have you ever had in a, like in a straight bar? Like sometimes you see in a movie, or I'm watching. There's a new show on Apple, Invasion. Are you watching that?
No. But I was just thinking. I just thought.
But there's a scene where this girl, like, she's dating another girl. They break up, or she's gone. She goes to a bar, and she's like making eyes with a girl across the club. Right. And it's like they both know they're gay.
Yeah,
they,
see, that's, you know. Well, that's for sure a thing. And I would
that is,
say,
like, you know when,
guy, oh,
like,
yeah,
someone's giving
like
you gay telepa- eyes?
Oh, yeah, it's telepathy. Yeah. It's really, we're good at that.
But that's what I mean.
All gay guys are twins.
But yeah,
this guy was way off.
Dude, I think I locked eyes with a dude, and like, I couldn't stop looking at him.
Well, you're kind of gay, Frank.
No, but like, I think I've gotten caught in those eyes things where I'm like, why is this guy looking at me? And I'm looking at him. That's happened to me before, where I'm like,
yeah.
That guy wanted to fuck.
Like, no matter where I looked in the office, I kept staring at him. I mean, not in the office, fuck. Jesus Christ.
Freudian slip.
I'm looking around in office, that's what I said. So it's definitely happened to me before, though. I'm like, dude, I'm looking at this guy way too much. Like,
but he's looking at you.
But like, I know, but I was like feeding into it.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
happened. I never heard that right, before. Like,
yes,
yeah,
so I would say, yeah, no, I mean, I would, yeah. I bet also I would say if this dude, I mean, if this kid seems like he's in college, like college could be a thing, I feel like.
Yeah.
Because like we only had like a couple bars. Uh-huh. And so like, but the thing was, obviously I knew like all the other gay people were, right. But mm-hmm. it's like you could probably try.
And who knows? Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe this guy does give off like crazy gay vibes. Like maybe that dude was like, you're you're not. Like, we all, everybody in the gay stable over here thought you were. Like, I don't know, but it seems on like three or four drinks, even let's say you
second
thought
drink,
it,
I'd right. be like,
even if you thought not, initially, yeah. by the time you're having a conversation, three or four drinks in, and he's talking about like his fantasy team or some shit, you're like, man, this guy, he's a straight fucking loser. You know,
we got a fantasy team. It's named Bishop Sycamore. You're gonna love it.
All right, next up. Good job from the gay guy.
Yeah, thanks. Hey, what's up? It's the Cracker Kid from Tuesday's episode. First of all,
I love it.
Kid that jerks off in the shower, searching for validation for the habit which I'm ashamed of.
Wait, hang on. Start up. Let's just start.
I will continue to do it now.
Just recapping that he's the kid that jerks off in the shower.
And recently, I had just jerked off, so naturally the first thing I go to do after is pee, because if you're not peeing immediately after you jerk off to clean out the pipes, I don't know what you're doing. I walk into the bathroom. And at the same time, in a stall nearby, walks in another kid on my floor, future U.S. Army veteran, true man's man, so naturally is an immediate Niagara situation coming from his stall, comfortably a stronger stream than anything I had ever mustered up in my entire life, truly an impressive feat. And things were taking a little while for the wheels to get turning over on my end. And so I went into fight or flight as he was finishing up business in his side of the bathroom, and I decided to turn around, pull my pants down, and pretend to be pooping that whole time so he wouldn't see me as less of a man for not being able to pee when I want. Is that the most pathetic thing you've ever heard?
Now, for context, the last episode, he filmed just peanut butter crackers. He's the one who put his face on. Okay. So he's officially the cracker kid.
Cracker Kid?
Cracker Kid is my new favorite person.
Cracker Kid, I love it.
I want to see how many types of crackers he can go through. Like, we're going to, you know, episode like 25.
Yeah, don't come in this house with fucking chips.
Yeah, no, crackers only.
Cracker Kid, bring crackers.
I don't want to see no cookies, no Fig Newtons, no chips. Handmade. I want crackers. Honeymade.
It's handmade. What the fuck is that? Netflix show?
Handmade sale up in this bitch.
Fuck. See, I have dementia.
I don't know what he's talking about. You don't have to pee every time you fucking
jerk. Yeah, I think
off.
He has a pussy.
Yeah, that's what girls have to do that flush out the bacteria. We probably like should, but we don't have to.
Well, the problem with not peeing right away after is that maybe you're in a public setting where then you're peeing. And then, no, not just drip, but it just comes out the sides.
Snake tongue. Yeah. One time I did that recently. Oh my God, I think I got a triple stream and it felt like I was passing a kidney stone.
Bro, I always feel weird like I'm going to pee on the dude's shoe next to me. Though. Think about that. Imagine you're fucking out of urinal.
Bro, what are you guys fucking? Your dicks are Moses?
When there's a little bit of cum in your dick.
No, I know what you're talking about, but like, I don't. Dude, all right, this is weird. So when I was a kid,
sounds like you don't.
I remember watching Me, Myself, and Irene.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
With my friend's dad. And
you watched a movie with your friend's dad?
I mean, like, I'm sure my friend was there or something like that.
You guys cuddle?
Did you fuck your friend's dad?
Yeah. I was going to say, if fucking Rude Judas, you got molested.
Like, but, if I'm ever watching a movie with Keegan's friends, fucking arrest me.
But we were watching Me, Myself, and Irene. And there is a scene where Jim Carrey, he goes to piss, right? After he, like, fucks. He wakes up in the morning and pisses.
Yeah.
And the piss is going everywhere. Right. And he, like, he's in a motel or a motel. And he, like, gets wrapped up in the shower curtain. And I was like, what's this all about? And he's like, that's what happens to your penis. And
I mean, this is the fifth time you've been sexually molested on the show. Five. No, I'm not exaggerating. Like, this is the fifth time he's told a story about being a child and having something inappropriate sexually happen to him.
And he was just like, when you get older, you'll get this. Like, that's what happens. You dick, you fucking piss everywhere once you fuck people. I was like, all right, man.
Dude, what the fuck is happening?
It's crazy. I think I have dementia too. From this motherfucker and his stories. It's crazy.
You don't understand what we're talking about?
But no, okay, so anyway, so I think because that's what was ingrained to me as a child,
right?
As like what your dick does.
You think you would get it.
Which was, no, but like, it's just such an extreme example where I was like, that's what happens to men's penises.
Yeah.
Where it's like, yeah, sometimes I have a little bit of like an offshoot, but like, I'm never fucking falling into a shower. I'm never like worried about pissing over, on someone else in the room.
I mean, dude, I've gone outside. I've missed the toilet.
Big time.
What?
Oh, yeah. Because, dude, it's like, think about it. It's like fucking having a hose, and then you put something in the middle of the hose. It goes out both sides.
Yeah, listen, you got a weak little stream,
it's
man.
It's like,
dude, I've pissed before where it's gone on the fucking curtain. You could hear it.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh! But like,
That's exactly it.
It wasn't that clean, that one.
That was really like unbelievably messy. That was like borderline sexual.
give me some water. I'll show you how it's done.
Imagine doing that and then it going on the guy next to you's leg. That's a nightmare.
But like, I don't think it goes. I did a porn dub. Let's see Kevin's.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, yeah. Yeah, you got it at the end there.
Like,
all
you
right.
Fucking drooled it down your chest like you were sucking dick.
That, I mean, that still happens with your dick, man. What happens with your dick?
Yeah, no, again, I've had it happen like a little bit, but I've just never been like, oh, shit, I might hit that guy around the corner.
It's happened to me, and then you got to push a little harder, and it clears it out.
Yeah. Or like, you know what the worst is? Wall or some shit. You know what the worst is? If you've got a little bit on your tip, and then that is like touching like the fabric of your boxers, and you almost get like some like lint.
Yeah. Oh, I've picked off lint before. Because
then it becomes like a mixture of lint and cum.
Yeah.
And that's like cement. Yeah. That's like you're cementing your whole shot.
That's how they made the Great Wall of China. It's just a bunch of lint cum and
they're
going
They're laying the bricks down. You try to pee with some cement in your tip, and it might back up. It might shoot back. You might not break through that thing. Frankie, let me tell you, we bring out the worst in us. You're awful, but you bring out the worst in us too. Don't worry, you're not alone.
But the to answer this kid's question, I love this kid. I really like him. He kind of reminds me of Spider a little bit. His tone.
He's got some swagger too.
Yeah, when he's future U.S. Army, but just gassing up dudes with good pit streams, which I get. Like when I'm taking a piss, I'm like I'm trying to fucking hit a stream.
He says he could hit that chair.
Frankie. Oh, I keep forgetting about this.
What?
He says he could piss from
the chair was closer. The chair was more with the camera.
No, it was not.
More with the camera.
Fine. That's like, fine. I'll give you that.
No.
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 You're old. Your prostate's getting shitty. You're
bro,
done.
My prostate tight, boy. Tight,
I went into the bathroom back here, and I stood three tiles away, which I thought was pretty impressive. It was probably like three or four feet almost, and I could do that.
Look, I'm
and
not
I, and, that, and it was like, that's like three times what I did. No fucking shot.
It's not a Vlad Guerrero. It's not a Yoenis Cespedes, but it's a fucking, it's a moonshot in. Like, it's fucking.
You got some.
I have to arc it. Like, nah, I mean, it's far. I'm like, I'm not saying I hit
so
it.
So far.
It's far.
No way.
But I said, and my, it, no I understand this probably it goes shot. Against my argument. If I went in front of the table, I definitely hit it. That's what I'm thinking here is, it's a long shot. That's a lot of addition here.
I don't think you do any of it.
Do this out like in fucking.
I know. I was
gonna
say, fucking prove it.
We gotta get
you
the.
Know what else
the...
is gonna happen? 80,000 subscribers, triathlon time.
Yeah.
We officially hit 80K.
Fuck yeah.
Jackie and Nick and Mike have to do have to do swimming, freestyle rapping, and a Google competition. So I will take care of the pool. We will find like a YMC. Actually, if any of you out there can somehow assist with us getting a pool, unfortunately, this was a summer idea.
The pool?
Nope. That's the best part of it. Yeah, you might die. That's why we, you know, that's where the real excitement comes in. So we will figure out a pool. Somebody,
is it a race or is it a
time?
They,
right?
Yeah, they both just have to complete a lap because
is
they,
the lap there back or just there?
Just there, because neither of them can swim. So I don't want to rest there.
I say we do there and back, and we rescue them if we have to.
Yeah,
I'd rather there be some danger here.
How could
I'm not going to let you guys drown.
Yeah.
But I would like to see you struggle.
Mike at least can, like...
Survive.
Stay, like, get around.
Yeah, Mike
I mean, is it
will
possible
drown.
For an adult to
it's
drown
crazy.
In a 5-foot pool?
Bro, he's from Long Island.
Up.
He's from Long Island and he can't swim. That's crazy.
That is insane.
I mean, you're missing
like,
the part where I
oh,
fell.
Oh, yeah, he almost died, right?
Died, yeah.
Yeah, what happened?
I fell into a pool when I was, like, 3, drowned, and then I just never got back in. But after...
It's not that dramatic. Sorry.
Bro, like I'm thinking Jackie. About like if Keegan almost drowned and like to the point where you like
they I had no breath like they
yeah yes, okay like Mike died.
I mean like I don't
Mike
remember
like was
it,
resuscitated.
I just never went back in the pool
yeah.
and that's why.
That's like your parents probably never wanted you in again and all that shit. Yeah. That I understand. If you need to be like resuscitated from death, that's different. Jackie, what's your excuse for sucking at swimming?
And being from California.
My parents just never, like, it's their fault. Like, they didn't put me in swim lessons.
Yeah, I mean, that is bad.
So that's, like, I didn't have a say. Like, if I had a say in it, I would teach myself how to swim, but I didn't have a say in it. So it's not my fault.
So why don't we do another thing where we teach you how to swim? Like, we'll do the triathlon, but we'll also do, like, Jackie learns how to swim.
No, because that's super embarrassing.
Why?
Because...
Put floaties on you.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll put you in, like, a little inner tube.
I'm not going to, like,
we'll get
publicly
you goggles
learn
and
how
some
to
flippers.
Swim as a 22-year-old. I'm not going to be putting floaties.
What I mean, what's worse, doing that as a 22-year-old or being like a 42-year-old who just can't swim?
I'll teach myself like in private, and then
come out one day,
and I'll come out one day, and I'll fly across the pool for a camera.
Why don't you start doing that? We'll schedule the triathlon. You have like a couple weeks to fucking
learn. You're describing training.
Yeah.
Training is allowed.
I'm going to train.
Also, he had a Truman Show type experience where, like, at a young age, they made him afraid of the water. That's,
yeah,
that's
horrifying. Yeah,
he got real problems.
Yeah, he's fucked. this is actually...
Truman Show where he, like, won't go into the water because his dad died in the water.
I'll be honest. I don't think I quite knew the extent of this, but... A deal's a deal. 80K
I jumped
is 80K.
In like this summer after it happened. It wasn't terrible, but I just don't know how to swim. Like, I'm not scared anymore. I just can't swim.
Yeah, like, I mean, we're not going to throw you in like rough waters or some shit. We'll probably
put
you in a pool where you can stand.
It's impossible for an adult to drown.
You would think that. They say you can drown in like 3 inches of water. Yeah. It's crazy.
I mean, Prince drowned in his puke, right? That Prince Jimi Hendrix.
Well, yeah, but I'm saying, like, can't you just stand up?
That's very different when you're fucking passed out from drugs and you puke, choke on your own puke.
Oh, I thought he was face down.
No, I don't know, but usually people die in the
pool. If I throw an adult in a 5 foot deep pool, you're telling me
5 foot you can stand up,
right? Like you're telling me they can't just
but like I got
like
a friend.
They're flopping around and they're just like, oh yeah, I can just do this.
I got a friend, the Big Wheeze. You throw him in the deep end of the pool.
Well,
and
that's a problem.
Yeah, like he would start thrashing. His line is always, "Why would I want to hang out in something I can't breathe in?"
That's a good point.
That's a good point.
That's a fucking good point.
Yeah, he also wants to go to space. But you know, we said 80,000 gets a triathlon, and here's the thing, guys. We're gonna make another thing for another benchmark, and if we don't do this, then they're not gonna subscribe because they're gonna say that we welch on all of our bets. So
yeah, you gotta swim.
Gotta swim.
Okay.
For the brand. For the brand.
If I'm playing devil's advocate, you also have to do an AMA for 70,000.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll do it tomorrow.
No, yeah. That's what I figured.
My real problem is that I still have to come and jump off a bridge for the Mets. How do I do that? I said if Pete Alonso hits 50 home runs and 120 RBIs, this is his rookie season, someone was like, Pete's going to hit 50. And I was like, yo, if Pete hits 50, I'll come myself and jump off a bridge. And he fucking did. And now everyone's like, the Mets aren't going to win. You're cursed until you do it. And I'm like, okay, I'll find a bridge that's like a little bridge, you know, and I'll just jump off it. I'm not thrilled about that either, but I'll find something, you know. But like, how am I gonna like do a video where I like cum myself
that's
without like
weird
going on a sex offender list, you know? As long as the public's cool with me, like I go in a room, close the door, I cum, honors promise, I came, and then we jump off a bridge. But that kind of shit makes me feel like I'm gonna end up on a sex offender list.
Why? If you,
like when
right,
my
so
kids
there's...
at school find, like when the parents and the teachers find out that I did a video where I came myself, like when I have to release a piece of content that's like KFC comes himself and jumps off a bridge, and I know the teachers that watch Barstool,
yeah,
you know what I mean?
That's tough.
That's not but good.
There's a bridge on Martha's Vineyard on by State Beach. It's on State Road, and I believe they have porta potties next to it in the summer.
Oh fuck. I can't jerk off in a porta potty.
Why not? And so,
smells
but,
and stuff.
So you can do it, okay? But it's not a big. It's the Jaws bridge. It's the bridge from the movie Jaws.
How high is it? You're talking
7 feet, 8 feet.
Okay, yeah.
Wow. And it's if you watch the movie Jaws, it's a bridge. The shark comes under and then goes into the lake. Jaws was filmed on the vineyard, and it's called Jaws Bridge. Come yourself with that porta potty and
have to
jump out. I didn't realize this was still a thing. I wouldn't have said it if you're actually looking for solutions. That could be one. We can cut it out if you're not looking for solutions.
You're right. Anyone will say anything to get their team something there. To fucking do well. I'd say some crazy shit for the Islanders, but I'm not going to because...
What's your new project?
Oh, yeah.
What?
The new project you tweeted out.
You do have dementia.
Oh, yeah, I'm doing... Well, it hasn't really been like talked about yet because it's got to be... Well, people could kind of piece it together. I do these things for like the U.S. Open, but I'm going to be doing it for the Islanders, opening up the arena. It's really cool shit. Like, I'm the only one that's been really given access to this new arena. I've been there, like, every day filming. It's cool. Fucking awesome, man. Like, watching this place, like, be built.
This is the Belmont place?
Yeah.
What's it going to be called?
UBS Arena. It's a bank. Okay. But it's fucking awesome. The place, like, dude, like, we were there, like, they were testing out the lights and, like, the projectors on the ice. And, like, they're hitting buttons and I'm flying the drone over the ice. And they're, like, testing out, like, the fucking logos where they're going to go and putting the ice down and painting the ice. And
how are the Islanders playing right now?
I don't want to talk about it. They're all right. Fucking 3-2-2. But I would eat my dog's ass if they want to fucking...
I'm with you on that.
I'd eat my dog's ass if they fucking ate a cup, if they want a cup.
Dude, they fucking are a good team. Like, that's a...
I'd probably eat my dog's ass.
That's a bull problem for a team that was like...
Were they the Eastern Conference Championship last year?
Yeah,
imagine if you did it. Yeah, 2 years in a row.
You're a fucking cunt hair from the cup.
Imagine if he did it.
Bro, I'll lift his hind legs up and you're just fucking... Little Maltese?
Little Maltese.
I'll clean him right out. He's got ass problems anyway.
Bro, oh, you've been, wait, that you've makes been it like worse. Five games from a Stanley Cup.
We were in overtime of game 7.
Imagine if he did it and they made it to the cup, but like through some magical sports god, they told him like, yeah, it was going to happen anyway. You didn't need to do that. Yeah. Like, they were going to make it regardless, dude.
Well, the team hears about it. They're like, dude, we got to take a dive tonight. Like, not watch that video, Frankie.
Somebody asked me today, would I take, like if I knew, and I couldn't gamble on it, so you can't like take advantage money, of that, yeah. But would you take knowing that the Islanders are going to win a Stanley Cup in 2027, or do you let the dice Do you roll the dice for the next? That's what I said.
Got a bird in the hand,
but
bro.
Then you ruin all the excitement. The excitement's about
that is true.
The fucking thrill, dude, and so going to each game. Like, essentially, I would get a note that says you can't tell anybody, you're not allowed to speak it out into existence, but the Islanders will win in 2027.
That would be crippling, man.
Crippling.
That might be why I say no, just because it's like that ruined my life. But I wouldn't worry about my excitement because I just want it to happen. What do you guys think of the Braves guys' celebration?
Which one was what?
Big T and the other kid. Last night the Braves win, and they were just like, but it was like 7-0.
I mean, the game was over.
The guy did, yeah, that kid did cry.
Who is that kid?
He's Travis's for the boys kid. That's all I know.
Yeah,
Gambling Cave was the move.
Gambling
kid.
Cave was the move. Remember that?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So I do kind of feel bad for him too. Where it's like, I don't know, he's like a new kid. Like he shouldn't. There's not even like a connection with him. Like, why do people even really care how he celebrates? You know right. what I mean?
Like also, like you didn't get to go watch him with his family. It's like brutal.
Yeah, yeah, know? Yeah.
It's like that.
But
guy.
I mean, did you have you seen this yet?
Yes.
I don't like to celebrate shame, but like, I don't know, man. You know, people are talking about the Atlanta curse, which is a little exaggerated in my mind. But like,
I was saying that last night. People were giving me like they're like all these things. If the Atlanta curse started to many people at 28-3, that's not a curse. And then they're like, Georgia football lost, and fucking the Braves last year or 2020 blew a 3-1 lead. Okay, so like
a few years.
I never thought of Atlanta as being like a cursed team.
There's
a bad team. You guys suck. It's funny. You lose in like, the way you lose is unbelievable.
Brutal, for sure.
But like, I never thought there was a curse on Atlanta.
By the way, this
is a great property. 45 minutes out. 49 minutes away from Truist Park. It is beautiful. Check it out.
Yeah, I'll give the tears. Those are the real. Because I think I'll cry. I will cry if the Mets win. But I mean, I don't know. See, like, even if you're up a lot and you know you're going to win, I feel like that ninth inning, I'd be like, one away. Yeah. We're going to do it. Two away. Right. It's happening. Yeah. Three. You know, I don't know.
They won in the 90s, right?
They won 95.
Right.
26 so, I mean, years.
It is like that's even if
26
even if there were
years
no,
since their last win.
The like, when, like, if I was enrolled in school your last fucking championship, you're not cursed. Right. But the, yeah, these things are kind of one of those things where it's like you can't win, right? Because like,
dude, people say I'm an overreactor right, and it's not it's, true right. and it's not fucking
yeah. These guys,
genuine,
I believe the Braves fans specifically. Granted, I think it was that other guy who said the southern accent. These guys were getting nailed because it would be like a fucking second inning like double and they'd be going crazy. So yeah, you really can't win.
No, if you're
but a World Series, I mean this
is the.
Like, it was funny because the tweet said, like, the Atlanta Braves are World Series champions. And this is the video. And people were like, Jersey Jerry was like, you guys tired?
Yeah.
The World Series.
I forget if it was a World Series win or a World Series game or whatnot. But, like, we had that with the Red Sox one where it was just like, boy, boys. But, yeah. Like, Boston is different because, like, that's kind of part of our thing where it's like,
yeah.
Another one.
I
whatever.
Mean, a World Series win, though. I mean, for the it'll be different if it's the Mets, I'll tell you that much.
Big time.
But it is weird in baseball.
Won game 6 at the Coliseum. They scored that goal, Anthony Bevilier. And I remember, I mean, I was weeping because I remember it was the last game at the Coliseum ever if they didn't make it to the Cup. Mm-hmm. And, like, just the idea of just, like, all the beers getting thrown on. Like, that's a moment. Like, for them, it's hard when they're in a fucking.
Yeah, you're sitting
in the
radio
room.
Yeah,
like,
it's, yeah.
I mean.
There's not much emotion.
I think the 7-0 is, like.
Huge
like,
difference.
For
2 hours, you know you're World Series champions.
Right.
That's hard.
Right. Like, I think Carl had a tweet where it was like, I celebrated more for a first down. Like, so have I.
Right,
I know the
but in that moment,
coming,
yeah, yeah, it's an exciting thing.
Like, wow, let's yes. go! Yeah, where yeah. it's like, yeah, if it's a walk-off, yeah, we're talking a completely different
right.
story.
Right.
But it is like you've known, at that point, you've known for 2 hours that you're winning.
Yeah.
Sure, there's a chance you can't, but
no,
it's you've been 99.9% sure you're winning the World Series for over 2 hours.
Right, right. All right, last video voicemail, what do we got? Is this Sexy Skyler? No, okay.
KFC, Fights, Nick, Superstar, Jacked Up, Jackie, whoever else might be there, what's up? I just got a question about the best karma you've ever had.
Oh, boy.
For me, this was a moment probably 4 or 5 years ago, back when I was in university. I was at a club with a bunch of buddies, and it was a super packed night. Everyone's, you know, sweaty, rubbing all over each other. It's a packed house. We were in line to get a drink, and the line was like a half hour long already, and we were moving nowhere. And this drunk girl comes in, this young girl starts throwing elbows in front of everyone, like, ah, I need a drink first. And I was like, you know what? I'm not drunk enough to deal with you. You go ahead. She had a $20 bill in her hand. She's in front of me and waving it around, and she ended up dropping it. So I bend over and hand it to her, and I tap her on the shoulder, like, hey, you dropped your money. And she shrugged me off. And I was like, hey, tap her on the shoulder. You dropped your $20 bill. She shrugged me off again. I was like, all right, fuck it, guys. I'm going over to the VLTs with her money. So I walk over to the VLTs, put her $20 bill in, and on the first spin, I won $680.
Holy shit.
Best instant karma moment of my life. I'm just wondering, what's the best karma moment you've ever experienced?
What's a VLT?
All right, have a good one, guys. Keep it up. Viva.
I did not know. It seems like a Canadian thing. Yeah, the casino aspect.
Is it VLT those scratchy things, or is it
video
like
lottery?
Video lottery.
So just some sort of
slots.
So it's a slot machine.
Slots, bro. They're the slots.
Yikes.
Best karma moment. I thought he said coma moment, and
what?
I thought he said coma moment.
Coma moment. Do you have a coma moment?
No. Okay. No. I was just like, that's going to be a hard one.
I have a reverse karma moment. I found money on the floor, the sidewalk. And I think it was like $20. And there was a person like a few feet ahead that is probably theirs. And I just put it in my pocket. And then I had like a vicious allergic reaction to alcohol. And like, and then I went through a phase. It's probably like why I really stopped drinking. Granted, it was when I was drinking shitty liquor. Every time I would drink like cheap vodka at the bar, I would get hives and my throat would like close up a little bit. And I would still just go out and drink like all the time. It's crazy. I would be like people would see me being like,
just like, it just ruins me. And I drink one every night.
Every night.
Every night.
Like, well, you drink it on the can?
What?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. You're like a chick. Like, I say this all the time.
Right through you.
Women are just lactose intolerant.
Yeah,
and they just complain all the time. They're like, oh, like this is like, no. They say they're lactose intolerant, but they just, all they do is
consuming massive amounts of dairy.
All they do is eat dairy.
I'm actually not going to say this on the air because I think it's pretty fucking gross.
It's okay.
I ate a fucking soft-served ice cream while I was taking a shit, dude.
That's literally some human centipede shit. It's
like just poop particles were going into the ice cream. Like, you gotta think, right? You're fucking actively shitting. And once I took the first lick, it just was like, ooh.
Using a cone?
Oh, yeah.
Dude, I thought...
I'm sitting naked. My fucking belly. Belly's hanging over. I've got my tits out, and I'm just sitting there pooping.
Do that noise again. He goes, when I got that first look, ooh.
It's just like, ooh.
You are deplorable.
Dude, that is... I am, even in my own bathroom, in my own home, food, absolutely. I wouldn't bring a water bottle in. I'll, like, throw a water bottle, like, on the couch. I'll throw a check. I will not carry a water bottle. I'm just taking a piss.
Dude, that's as bad as it's ever been.
Like, but a fucking hole in this cone while you're dumping out Leonard's. Your fucking cornhole is...
At Stu Leonard's?
From Stu Leonard's.
Oh. Like, were you doing this at a grocery store?
No, dude.
All right. Jesus
By the way, I don't remember anything. The karma thing, I don't have one instance.
I have one, it's not like karma, but it's like satisfaction is when like someone's like fucking speeding past you on like a rural route, and then like you go through that light, and then the next light you see him wrapped around a fucking pole.
Jesus.
Nah, I'm kidding. That hasn't happened. I hope for it every time.
Gotta go to LA and start driving with some TikTokers.
Every single time I fantasize, like, oh, yeah. You fucking dickhead with riding my ass. When I get around this corner, you are going to be fucking wrapped around a ball. But it hasn't happened yet.
Anyway, interview time. We got Gary Gulman on the show. We also got Sam Morril, two unbelievably funny comedians. We'll start off with Gary. It's brought to you by Thursday Boots. Thursday Boots, we've collabed with them for our boots, also with our sneakers. They own the company Nothing New, who we collaborated with for our sneakers. They made the Moon Man ones and the Sad Boy Season ones. Moon Man ones.
I can't take mine off as easily as Kevin. Kevin's got the slip-on.
I got the slip-ons or the lace-up. You can do it any way you want. The slip-on or the lace-up with the black denim up on top. Casual shoe, you know, a staple for any sneaker, oh, yeah, for any closet. We still have these in stock. We Feitelberg sold out in like 4 minutes. We upped the ante, upped the quantity for Moon Man 1, so you can still grab some sizes of these. The Moon Man, the Sad Boy Season 1s are coming later this season.
I would say in a month.
Okay. So around
Black
Friday.
Don't hold me to that. I have no control over
it. I would probably say, it's December. It'll be okay. December. A month. It's November, right?
It's November, yeah.
I think it'll be like mid to late December because... So that's nothing new. So you can get the sneakers from the Barstool Store, or you can go to ThursdayBoots.com, get yourself a pair of boots, whether you're going to brunch, whether you need some military boots, whether you're doing like Chelsea boots, whether you're doing suede, leather, whatever, all the different styles, all the different materials. They all start at just $149 with free shipping and free returns. These are boots that would cost you hundreds and hundreds of dollars anywhere else, but they've passed on all their savings by being an online company that really, I mean, Thursday Boots has blown the fuck up. I will shoot you straight. When we were like one of the first companies they advertised with, and the first boots they sent us were, they were tough. And their quality has gotten like unbelievably better over the years. They now are like high quality boots at an affordable price. They've grown to be a really, really impressive company. That's why we do our collabs with them for boots and for sneakers. So go to ThursdayBoots.com, ThursdayBoots.com. Get a pair of high-quality boots that you'll be wearing for years, and head over to the Barstool Store to get your sneakers. It's Gary Gulman on KFC Radio.
What was the circumstance?
I was in... It was a room bigger than this, but it was probably 15 of us doing the books or balance sheets for what is now probably owned by three different things that were... Anyhow, it was an investment mutual fund, and I was being really loud and entertaining, and somebody said, Gary, the client is like right outside the door. And I'm like, what are they going to do, fire me? And I had to walk into the human resources, and they were like, it says here that you said, quote, what are they going to do, fire me? And I said, I'll get my things.
It won't unlock, so I'm just like... I'm just like, can you unlock the, can someone unlock this? And no one's there. So I start, I look through my itinerary. I start texting the club manager. I'm like, can you guys get me out
of the bathroom?
And I'm like, I don't know what to do. So they come and they're like, it won't open. And I'm like, well, he's calling my name. I got to get out of there. So Gary's literally going, Sam Morril. And they're clapping. They're like, what the hell? And I'm like, well, what do we do? And I was like, can I kick the door in? Do you care if I kick the door in?
Did you do it?
I did it.
Wow. Yeah.
I thought
how many
it was.
Kicks?
Well,
all right. The holiday season is approaching. All I want for Christmas this year is YouTube subscribers. We got to get to 100,000. I want
Please,
that 100,000 plaque.
Can you buy these subscribers?
We've got a goal for all you out there, for everybody. At 100,000 subscribers, Polly Feitelberg will join us on the show, maybe. Well, if not, we'll probably have to trick her into it. But at 100K, you will get Polly content. So subscribe, click the bell icon so you get notifications so that you're always watching. Leave a comment below. Talk about it. Post about it. Spread word. Tell your friends. 100,000 subscribers on KFC Radio for Polly Feitelberg. Let's make it happen.